you want to win the gold no matter what tournament, but especially World Juniors.
The standard is a gold medal every single year.
Edmonton, Alberta, where the weather has been spectacular from start to finish at this first ever and hopefully last Summer World Juniors. And after three tries, a bubble tournament in 2021, a canceled tournament in Christmas, fans will finally get to watch a gold medal game here. Kent Johnson and Team Canada wearing their black jerseys today. They wore those the last time they won gold back in 2020. Taking on a Finland team that says they relish the underdog role. They used to be the pesky Finns, not anymore. They are now a powerhouse at the World Juniors. As we say hello, Canada, and welcome to the gold medal game here at the 2022 World Juniors. James Duffy alongside Bob McKenzie, 1995 World Junior gold medalist Jeff O'Neill, and eight-time World and Olympic champion Cheryl Pounder for Canada and Finland. It's taken eight long months to get here. And when this tournament was canceled back in December, the 19-year-olds who were running out of eligibility thought their World Junior dream was over. But they were given a second chance. And though this tournament has been different, being in the summer, much smaller crowds until today, those kids on both Canada and Finland are exactly where they've always dreamed of being. One win from gold. To get you ready for it, Gord Miller and Mike Johnson.
James, Logan Stankoven has been a playoff performer all year long for the Kamloops Blazers. 17 goals in 17 postseason games, and Mike, he has scored in both medal round games here for Canada and against Czechia. He was 21-2 on faceoffs.
So given his track record, we probably shouldn't be that surprised that as this tournament has progressed, as the games have gotten more important, Logan Stankoven has gotten better and better. In fact, he's probably been Canada's best forward the last two or three games. The points are there for sure. You can see why he was the CHL Player of the Year. The faceoffs are ludicrous. He's over 75% on the tournament, let alone the 93% he was in the semifinals. It's an important part of the game, starting with the puck, and his energy, his offense, and the fact that his line is now the go-to offensive line, with Mason McTavish taking on more of a checking role, will be pivotal for Canada to try to win a gold today. He has been great. I would expect him to be really good in the gold medal game.
And James, 11 years ago, Dave Cameron coached Team Canada in the gold medal game of the World Junior in Buffalo. Canada blew a 3-0 lead in the third period, lost 5-3 to Russia. 4,245 days later, he's back coaching the Canadian juniors in the gold medal game.
All right, thank you, gentlemen. Here is the Team Canada lineup that Dave Cameron will ice today. Remember, Ridley Gregg, who's been such a huge factor for Team Canada, injured his shoulder in the quarters. He is out. They had to shuffle the lines before the semifinals. 16 of these players are back from that canceled tournament in December. The Logan Stankoven line has been massive for Canada. It will have to be offensively again. Besides that line, who has to lead Canada to gold today?
Mason McTavish. He's played the whole tournament like he only wants one thing, James, and that's a gold medal. Every shift he was out there, he was effective through the whole tournament. Canada's best player, the tournament's best player, and I'm Dave Cameron. I'm double shifting him the first 10 minutes of this hockey game. Get him out there and get momentum going for Canada.
Zellweger and Sabrango, they have to be effective on the back end for Canada. You know Zellweger has the opportunity and the ability to walk the offensive blue line, good first pass decisions. But Sabrango, I mean, so defensive in his own end. They are going to have to shut down the Rapchu line and be so strong on the cycle and effective there to shut it down.
Here comes Team Canada onto the ice for the gold medal game.
Come on, 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 come on
Bob McKenzie, the key for Canada today.
Well, by any objective, Team Canada is more skilled than Team Finland. That said, they outskilled them and outwilled them in the preliminary round game. They know they're going to get a much bigger pushback from Finland in a gold medal game. And they also know when Finland's at its best, and they've won 3 gold medals in the last 9 years, this team, even though they're not as skilled as Canada, they are greater than the sum of their parts. Canada cannot be outgoaled or outwilled in this game, or they'll lose the gold medal.
And there's no time to get comfortable, James. The coach has got to get 2.5 lines going here, so you can't feel your way through the first period. Get pucks in, get pucks out, all the little things that the coach has confidence in you.
Yeah, exactly that, O'Donnell. Dictate, set the tone, set the pace right from puck drop.
This is not Canada-USA or Canada-Russia in terms of rivalry, but still the early days of a growing rivalry. Finland has handed Canada some of its most painful defeats over the last decade, most notably 2 quarterfinals, the worst game to lose at the World Juniors in 2016 and 2019, that crusher in overtime in Vancouver. It's Canada-Finland for gold. Gord Miller and Mike Johnson on the call.
Thank you, James. And there's what's on the line today. The World Junior Championship for 2022, delayed from December and January, but completed now in August. And Canada and Finland will meet each other for the 8th time in the medal round at the World Junior, the first time in the gold medal game. The officials, Sean Fernandez from the United States, Christopher Holm from Sweden are the referees, Andreas Holm from Germany, and Canada's Cody Cusby works the lines. We had a Czech linesman work the bronze medal game between Czechia and Sweden earlier. And there is 19-year-old Juha Jakkola from Kuopio, Finland, plays for his hometown team in the SM League of the Finnish League. Has played sparingly in this tournament, but the shutout in the semifinal. Dylan Garand, 19-year-old from Victoria, BC. The Ranger fourth-round pick in 2020 allowed 2 goals on 32 shots in the semifinal win against Czechia. Antti Pettinen, second time as the head coach of their national junior team. And there is Dave Cameron, head coach of the Ottawa 67s. 11 years later, he refuses to talk about redemption or revenge.
Hold up.
But you know what's on his mind.
Congratulations on the gold medal game, men. Let's have a good one here. Okay, this one's dedicated to Miss Eleanor. Lord, back up to you.
And here we go. It feels and sounds like the World Junior should. Owen Zellweger, the top point getter among defensemen of the tournament, up for Mason McTavish, who leads the tournament in points. Jakkola plays it around the glass, gloved down by Zellweger, but a skip by him to Donovan Sabarenko. This tough defense pair for Canada goes back to work. Sabarenko, lead pass, and brought in by Dufour. William Dufour, in a backhand shot, goes wide. Dufour trying to become the 25th player to win the Memorial Cup and the World Junior Championship in the same season. World Cup champion with the St. John Sea Dogs. Here's Ruben Rafkin back with it. He's only lost so far to Canada in the preliminary round. And Durant plays that around, picked up now by Forster. In comes Tyson Forster, backhands that in. As Kent Johnson goes after it, plays it back at the point. Jack Thompson with the Sault Ste. Marie Greyhounds, back down to Johnson. Jack Johnson spins it back around, and here's Forster on it. Back at the point, Roland Seeley. Across to Thompson, shoots! That was blocked in front, Johnson reaching for it. Johnson tried to center it, that went through the crease. Seeley steps back up. Plays it back down to Stankoven. Logan Stankoven in, shoots, and Jakkola makes the stop. At the end of the play, Johnson thrown down.
This was the line that got it going for Canada in the semifinals. They were absolutely dominant to start that game, and moving off the puck, creating turnovers, and Stankoven rolling around the top of the circle, and he's got the release that can cause problems. But when they move their feet off the puck, they are so tough to contain. Stankoven picking right off where he left off in the semis.
Nathan Gauthier for the faceoff. And a scramble draw, one back. And the puck bounced away from Will Kulik. Back to center ice it goes, and Played around by Ethan Del Mastro, who got the call from Canada just days before the tournament opened. After Damon Hunt was injured in one of the final practices before the tournament. And here's Connor Bedard, scored a spectacular goal against Finland in the round robin. He has 4-6 games. Cooley, in on the forecheck, that's taken away by Emil Viro. And back at center ice, it's poked back by Lucas Cormier. Del Mastro, lead pass for Gauthier. Ahead to Bedard. In comes Connor Bedard, a backhand shot that goes wide. And Bedard knocked the stick out of the hands of the Finnish defender, Samuel Hellenius. In comes Sabrango. Spins it back around, Zellweger steps up. Back in the corner it goes, and after it is Offman, Brendan Offman knocks that down. At the line, picked up by Zellweger. Holds the line, feeds it back in front, that's picked up by Amosalmi. Gets it high in the air and back down to the Canadian zone. Sabrango. Out there for a stop shot, drops it back to Offman, it rolled off his stick, and here's Hellenius back with it. His dad, Sammy, played the World Junior Championship back in 1993 and spent 7 years in the NHL. Zellweger up ahead for Denoyer for a stop shot. Canada changing, the stop shot works in, drops it back, Denoyer in, shoots, deflected puck, bounced away, a stop shot back on it. At the sign of the goal, Wall reaching for it. And back at the point is Thompson for Seeley. Back to Thompson, off the bench comes McTavish. Rock City fans on the shot, gets it back in. Another chance, kicked away by Akala. Back in the point is Thompson with it. Jack Thompson shoots, deflected puck in front. Rebound to McTavish, Akala's down. And he corrals the rebound as Canada gets multiple good looks in the early going.
Canada buzzing, playing with the kind of pace and intensity that you would expect. In the gold medal game, Mason McTavish not happy that he fans on the shot. He walks in, he's trying to go upstairs, but it goes right over top of the puck, but stays on it. And all these loose pucks, right now Canada is just a half step quicker to it. Off the breakout, Stapchuk gets the middle of the ice, exactly where you want to go. Cross and drop. Canada already getting to the slot more often. Sweden was able to against Finland in the semis.
Kaspar Kuopio sends that down. He scored the only goal for Finland in the semifinal win against Sweden. The 1-0 victory, scored the power play. And the Finnish power play has been lethal in this tournament. That shot blocked, picked up by McTavish. And now McTavish works in 3-on-2. Swings it across to DeFore. DeFore crunching the corner. Tied up there by Gugio. And now spinning back is Finland's Yuli Jormo, but DeFore had retrieved his stick, so he was actually able to forecheck it. Jormo swings it back across for Simon Taibo. Kaspar Simon Taibo works in and shoots off the outside of the goal frame. And brought back by McTavish. Along with Kent Johnson, McTavish works in, plays that back down. He needs a change as Johnson goes in. McTavish though remains out. Played back down low, and now McTavish will head off as Stankoven comes on for Canada. First ever meeting of the World Junior gold medal for these countries, but they've met in the last three men's World Championship gold medal games. Canada won a controversial one in Tampere back in May. Stankoven back after it. DeForest trying to poke that ahead. Puck kicked back in front. In comes Bison and shoots. Ripped that wide. It bounces off the inboards under the back of the net. And Kapanen pokes it back. Laid back in by Viro. Here's Bison. Cormier falls. Bison gets loose. Tries to throw that back in front and Garand pounces on that. So we talked about this being the first ever gold medal game meeting between these two countries. Canada has faced Russia 9 times, the United States 5, Sweden 4. This format began in 1996 with a medal round as opposed to the straight round robin.
Given how successful we know Canada has been since the inception of this format and this tournament, in Finland, it's in the last 10, 12 years, it's quite surprising to hear that they have not played in the final. It's only a matter of time given how good they both are every year.
Faceoff was won by Hellenius, who scored against Canada in the preliminary round. Now that's picked up by Hellenius. Works it in, shoots, it goes off a leg and wide, picked up by Seeley. Chops it around to Del Mastro. Del Mastro up ahead for Cooley, chips it ahead quickly and brought up by Gauthier. Gauthier for Bedard. Connor Bedard taking to the end boards hard as Rafkin slammed into him. Bouncing puck in front, that's gloved down by Rafkin. And ahead he goes to Hellenius, who needs off the ice. Rafkin peels back as the Finns are changing.
Rask has the confidence. Not dumping it in. He's going to take it back for a regroup and allow his team to change.
Atu Ratu has been a top player for Finland in the tournament. 10 points in six games. This game features the sixth top point getter so far in the tournament. Ratu, a centering pass broken up by Del Mastro. And ahead for McTavish. Out there with Bedard and Waugh. Bouncing puck, and Bedard was slammed there at the blue line. Bumped him offside, and Canada has to tag up. Now stripped away from Kemmel. In comes Waugh. Waugh works it and shoots and just missed high. Knocked down, but it's squirted away from Zellweger. Olin Zellweger. Lead pass to DeForo, knocks it in for Waugh. McTavish now centering Waugh and DeForo, taking the place of Ridley Gregg, who was injured in the quarterfinal against Switzerland. Alexa Himmelselmi, second round pick of Carolina. Lines that into Roby Järvinen. In comes Mata, shoots and fires that wide. It skips off the inboards as Järvinen couldn't reach it. Mata plays it back down. Here's Zellweger with it. Zellweger looks it high in the air, bouncing puck. Ostapchuk had that mistake and was poked away by Topi Niemela. Oh, kicking a lot of boards by Hoffman, slammed into Mata. Denoyer comes in on Simon Taibel. And the crowd roaring with every hit and every chance.
Hoffman's the kind of player that the home crowd would grow to love.
Kapanen sends that rink wide, poked ahead by Ikaliukas. And Hoffman has it back. Across he goes to Cormier. And Lucas Ooh. Cormier fires that down. Ostapchuk reaching for it. Plays it back down to Denoyer. Brought out now by Kapanen, ahead to Vaisanen. Over Kapanen, the nephew of longtime NHLer Sammy Kapanen, big hit by Liukas, slammed into Ostapchuk. Back comes Demoyer, drops it off to Cormier. Lucas Cormier winds in, throws it back in front. Johnson failed that shot and put it wide.
I think he'd be surprised that it got all the way through to his stick.
Now Stankoven with a steal, flips it back in front, bounces towards the goal, Forster a chance, rebound, and a save by Jäkkilä. Another chance, fired by Forster, another save by Jäkkilä. Center, Stankoven fires, and Jäkkilä another save, Johnson back with it. Chances piling up here for Canada, remains scoreless, but ain't gone here in the opening period. Johnson, game center ice that was poked away by Kapanen. Seeley with it. Ronan Seeley chips out ahead. Whoa! Finds Johnson. Drops it back off to Stankoven. Stankoven back for Johnson. They crisscross in the corner. Stankoven plays it back. Logan Stankoven has it taken away by Pudio. And Pudio being harassed there by Johnson and Stankoven. And Pudio forced back again. Stankoven all over and forces that free. Johnson comes in for it. Now Stankoven has it. And Ratu came back to take that away from him. Rolling puck back to the Canadian zone. Icing waved off as Sabrango goes back. Zellweger. Lead pass and Gauthier.
Just had too many men on the ice, that's why.
In comes Kemmel, shoots. He put that high and wide. And McTavish back on it. Puck rolls to DeForo. You know, Himmelselmi, he turns him, drops it back. McTavish in, shoots. And the save is made by Jäkkilä. Tremendous pace here in the first period. Big hits all over the ice. It's Canada and Finland in the gold medal game at the World Junior Hockey Championship for the very first time.
Canada off to a really good start in this game, out shooting Finland 5-0, 9 minutes in. And once again, it was the Stankoven Johnston Forster line that had all kinds of chances banging around the net, broken plays, and Jäkkilä quickly side to side tracking that loose puck. And Johnson, and so many of them. This one is best of the bunch. Locker it aside. Really well done by Jäkkilä. And you don't have to be the biggest to be good on the forecheck. You gotta be active. Active stick, active legs, and Stankoven much smaller than Puccio. Able to create a loose opportunity and a little chit-chat. I don't think this is friendly, Jäkkilä and McTavish. After the last save, gonna get you eventually. You know what Mason's saying?
Faceoff was won by Mata. But Stankoven knocks it down again. Centers it, that just missed Forster. Tyson Forster back on it to the point. He goes to ceiling. Back across to Thompson. Winds and shoots. It goes off a skating wide. Bouncing puck picked up by Mata. Rafkin up through center ice. Mata had that knocked away by Stankoven as Jack Thompson picks it back up. Into the Curtis, Ontario, just east of Toronto. Up for Kent Johnson. Johnson works in, has time and shoots. It goes off the foot of Cudjo, bounces right back in the slot, and picked up by Niemela. Tuffy Niemela, the top defenseman of the 2021 tournament. Banks it back to center ice. Liukas on it. And now Cudjo being forced there by Gauthier. Gauthier got clipped with a stick. And back goes Sabrango with a quick look. For Seeley, chips that to Bedard. Connor Bedard feeds out ahead. Rink wide pass by Sabrango goes off the stick of Gauthier over the glass and out.
So this is the second game between Finland and Canada in this tournament, and Coach Antti Pettinen was asked how he felt about their team's chances after having lost to Canada in the round robin. He said, well, I liked how we played when we had our good moments. And the one thing we learned is that Canada's not very good in their own end. That was a quote. They're not very good in their own end. So plenty of motivation for Canada to clean that up and get a sense of what Finland would like to try to do, get it in, get a cycle going against Canada.
Knocked back of the line, that long shot. Deflects wide of the goal. It was taken by Yermo. And now busting it is Hoffman. Has a look back for a stop check. Hoffman got a center that was broken up, now stolen back. Hoffman centers it. That's taken back by Roni Karvonen. And here is Yermo with it. Plays for Jokerit in the Finnish league. He was with Jokerit in their junior program. Jokerit Helsinki, the famous club that played in the KHL the last 10 years, has left that league, will not play this year in Finland. And their status yet to be determined for the season after this, but they will rejoin the Finnish SM Liga at some point. Stapchuk sends it back in. Knocked down by Jäkkilä. 5-0, the shots on goal for Canada. 9 to go here in the opening periods. Canada scored 3 goals against the Finns in the first period of their last meeting. Kimasami had that knocked away, icing waved off. Joshua Law comes in after it. Now knocked down for McTavish. McTavish works in, moves to the side of the goal, spins back and shoots. Jäkkilä saves it, and that score! Joshua Law! And Canada's got the lead!
Perfectly executed forecheck that starts with Joshua Law. Of course, him will saw me turn it over because he's about to get hit, get back to the front of the net. And Jäkkilä coughs up a juicy rebound on the wrap attempt from McTavish. But it all starts with finishing and then getting back to the front of the net and keeping your stick loose. And Joshua Law, who had an incredible offensive season this year with Sherbrooke, jumps on the loose puck to open the scoring.
He led all Canadian skaters in ice time in the semifinal against Czechia.
What an evolution for Joshua Law. You never would have thought coming into this tournament he'd be on the checking line
right
at the most important moments. And here he is on the checking line scoring two goals.
Start on the top line with Bedard and McTavish. They get switched up. And McTavish draws the assist. That's 16 points for him in the tournament. 2 off the Canadian record for most points in one World Junior Championship.
Puck was into the bench. Face off outside the circle, outside the blue line.
8:19 to go in the opening period. Joshua Waugh from Saint-Georges, Quebec, the Montreal fifth rounder, has the opening goal of the game as Canada leads 1-0. Need you like the sun when the clouds turn gray.
Oh, we like Joshua Waugh. Get back, get his heart rate back under control after opening the scoring, but as this tournament's gone on, his attention to the little details, defensively, forecheck, being physical, has allowed him to be more effective as the tournament's gone on, and a big goal for him. And it's not like he hasn't scored. That's his 8th point in 7 games.
Well, a reminder that Canada's so-called checking line has Mason McTavish, who played 9 games in the NHL and has scored everywhere he's been, and 250 goal scorers from the Quebec League.
Sometimes the best defense has got to be a good offense.
Bedard was spilled there. Gauthier knocks it down. Bedard, one of 11 Canadians who's eligible to return next year, including most of their top players. McTavish, Stankoven, Zellweger, all among those players who are young enough to play in Halifax and Moncton in December. Rink wide pass to Vaisanen. Vaisanen walks it and shoots. Grant makes the stop. Hangs on to the rebound. Takes a late whack there from Kapanen. And that's going to cause trouble in the Canadian crease.
Kapanen's a bit of a disturber. He's had a couple of these incidents in this game. He's had several throughout the tournament. And Garand didn't handle that one cleanly. He kind of got stuck under his pad. And understandably, Finland's going to go poking at something that might look a little bit loose. Kind of sealed under. And anytime you take a dig at a goaltender in any league, at any level, it's going to draw a crowd, which I think is half the point for Kapanen. And here you see Joshua Waugh. The ability to be able to read the puck off a goaltender. It's a skill. It's like Dennis Rodman on a rebound of a missed shot. Like, you get to, it's a feel about where it's going to end up. And you saw Waugh react more quickly to get there.
There's his parents looking on nervously. What a year their son had.
Yeah.
Led the Quebec League in points. He had 5 penalty shots in a 2-month period.
Well, you score 51, you get 120, 119 points in the season. Any offensive statistic's going to be eye-popping.
By the way, that was Finland's first shot. And they'll roll the faceoff, comes outside. But their first shot comes 12 minutes and 5 seconds into the first period.
Which is great news for Canada. But I imagine Dylan Garand would have, you know, you want to get in the game. You want to settle the nerves, touch the puck. Now he's got that under his belt.
So McTavish for the faceoff against Atu Ratsu, the Islanders' second-round pick.
And we'll watch this matchup all game long. Dave Cameron will look for it anytime he can get it.
Canada is the home team, has the last change as Zellweger banks that in. Knocked down by Jurmo. Now a chance in front, Logan! And this time Yackel able to turn him away, but Joshua Waugh flying in the early going.
It's the aggression of Canada on the forecheck. This one's Zellweger, so he kind of dumps it in. He doesn't stop, though. He seals that wall off, and then a brilliant pass from McTavish. Rips it across, and the handle is quite nice. To get it flat at the toe of your stick when it's coming that hard is not an easy thing to do. And Ross shows a good hand to handle it, just didn't elevate it quite high enough.
Stankoven wins the faceoff cleanly back to Thompson for Seeley. Seeley back down to Johnson. In shoots. Yackel will stop. Rebound the side of the goal picked up by Forster. Forster plays it back to Seeley. Crossy goes to Thompson. Thompson trying to find the stick of Johnson there. Forster's got it back. Forster to Seeley. Thompson again. Works it and shoots. That deflects wide. Seeley back on. Played down to Stankoven. And Logan Stankoven, who plays for his hometown team in Kamloops, has that bank back. They got all the way to the Western Conference Final in the Western Hockey League before falling to Seattle. He had 4 hat tricks in the playoffs for Kamloops. There's an icing call against Canada with 7:04 to go here in the first.
It's, we say he's 75% in the faceoffs, but not only is he winning the faceoffs, it's almost how he's winning them. Clean every time, snapping it back to whoever's standing behind him. And when you have someone who's that proficient, you can run plays, you can do set plays for your wingers. And Johnson, of course, are getting the hang of that.
Lost that one to Mata. Rapkin drops that down to Yarmouth. He shoots and Garand steers that away. Seeley peels back in the corner. Bumped there by Mata. Stankoven knocks it free for Thompson. And Jack Thompson flips it high in the air to center ice, looking for Johnson. That skipped away from him. Canada's changing. Johnson fell. Madison's at rink wide. It goes off the skate of Yarvinty, the Ottawa draft pick. And now Rapkin up in for Seaman Tybel. And banked in now by Liukas. Del Mastro lost his stick, couldn't handle that pass, but Cootie, a long shot, blocked away by Garand. Yermo loose at the point, being watched there by Denoyer, the loose puck in front. Had it down by Del Mastro. And here's Hoffman back with it. Slides it back to Del Mastro. And it's shipped back down by Denoyer as Canada changes. Here comes a snap chuck on the forecheck on Puteo. Bedard steps into Puteo. And Del Mastro plays it back around. Hoffman pokes it back, gloved down by Hamasalmi. Picked up now by Kapanen. Works in. Kapanen had a roll off his stick. And Del Mastro plays it back across, but not out. Hamasalmi has that pass intercepted by Cormier. And back around he goes to Del Mastro. Up ahead for Bedard, who taps it back to Cormier. The two-time Quebec League defenseman of the year. Lead pass from McTavish. Escape blades come off here.
Kemmel's
lost his blade. Wall back in front, knocked away. Kemmel taking off the ice. It's 5-on-4 right now.
So Brangle's got to recognize it and get involved in the play. Don't worry about the guy behind you.
McTavish to Wall. Got it by Cormier. Back to Wall. In shoots. That was blocked. Bouncing puck in front. Goes back to Wall. Here's Sabrangle with it. Centers it. Bedard had it. Now, the goaltender, Yakula, was spilled. He's arguing with the official. And Ratu, lined up by Bedard. Inside five to go in the opening period. Shots now 8-3 in favor of Canada. Simon Thibault works in. Drops it back. The return pass knocked away from Yarmonty, but kept alive by Rafkin. Wah. Tries to slide that ahead. Taken away by Mata. And back at the point is Rafkin. Feeds it across. Yamala shot. Grand. A good save on that. Zellweger back around. He goes for Sabrango. And both teams will change here as we've got 4.5 to go in the first period.
I want it.
You want it?
Johnson. Aims center ice. Moves it across the line. It is poked away but bounces right back to him. Johnson with Canada changing defense. Throws that to the open corner as Seeley comes on. Zellweger in deep. Johnson backing him up. And Zellweger, his stick is being held. And play continues. Yermo spins away. Away comes Helenius, who fires that down in the Canadian zone. Garan chops it down. Back around. Johnson at the line. Flip back in. That was offside. Should have been. They said the puck was on the line. The Canadian coaching staff right away going to the communication to make sure that this could be reviewed if necessary. Now a chance on the side of the goal. And Kerman knocked away. Johnson. End of his shift, digging to, and sending it back down to the finish zone. Emil Viro, the Detroit third-round pick, sends it in. Detroit's got 9 prospects playing this World Junior Championship, the most of any team. Bison and knocked down, Hoffman back with it. Swings that back for Cormier. Thompson back to Cormier. Canada's away. Cormier slides it back for Ostapchuk. Working in a Zach Ostapchuk, a backhand shot goes wide. Hoffman back with it. He shoots. Deco couldn't find it. Then way back on a wraparound try. Rebound loose in front. Hoffman couldn't reach it. And Joachim Kemmel's got it back. Number 2 in scoring to McTavish in this tournament. Kemmel comes in. The first round pick of Nashville. Cormier looks back for O'Rourke. Bouncing puck in front. Great chance there. Kermit turned away. Ronnie Kermit in the Finnish captain. Stop point blank by Garand. Here they come again. Ratu shoots, Grant makes the stop, and is able to hang on. Joshua Waugh has a gold medal game goal for Canada. 1-0 to score with 2:25 to go in the first.
Hockey Kemmel, the first rounder to Nashville, had a very good tournament, one of the offensive leaders for Finland, and he's got a whole bunch of points, goals, great release, power play, 5-on-5, you name it, he's been doing it, and with great precision, all kinds of different ways to score for Kemmel, but you can't score if you don't have a skate blade. As he crashed in the boards, the steal pops out, and oh, he doesn't recognize, he's like, okay, hang on, now I know it. He did a pretty good job getting off with just one blade there on the hop. And those are the new pop-out blades. Not the graceful dismount, but there's a little screw that you push in. You can pop them out, so if you lose an edge, you don't have to take your skate off to sharpen it. You just take the steel out in, like a NASCAR, in 15 seconds, you can put the new piece of steel back in right. And get back on the ice.
But they do pop out once in a while.
And that's the risk you run for the convenience of always having a fresh blade in there. You may occasionally have it fall out in the middle of the game.
Here's Putio with it. Up ahead for Seeley. And Forrester goes back. Tyson Forrester from Alliston, Ontario, has a big gathering of friends and family here. They've been loud all week. Johnson plays it back around. Thompson, bumped there by Yarvinsy. Centering pass and a quick chance there, fired wide by Mata. Johnson back on it. Finn starting to apply some pressure here late in the period. Picked off by Mata. Slides that back to Yermo. And Yermo beats it down to Yarvinsy. Ronan Sealy from Olds, Alberta, a couple hours south of here. Up ahead for Stankoven, puts it across, Forster works in, holds and shoots! And Yakula got a piece of that. Simon Tyvel, being harassed there by Johnson. And back to pick it up is Zellweger. Zellweger falls, but he regains his footing and settles things down as Canada gets some fresh legs on the ice. Dufour, up for McTavish. Lead pass to Dufour. Puts his way in. Waugh tried to seal the wall, now McTavish does. Mason McTavish knocks it down. Sabrango back to pick it up. Final minute now of the opening period. Sabrango up ahead for McTavish. He's got Waugh with him, trying to backhand that pass back in front for Dufour. That's broken up and brought away by Ronnie Carvinen. Carvinen in, and Sabrango knocked him off the puck. Zellweger. Liukas knocked down that clearing attempt. Back at the point. Yemela's shot. Pad saved by Garand. McTavish lays it back around to Zellweger. And Zellweger to the line again. Not out. Knocked down by Rafkin. That long shot deflects high from Carvinen. Waugh bats at it. Yemela stepped into him. And the puck was back to center ice. Fired right back in by Rafkin. And Garand has to leave it there for Sabrango. Out to center ice, often reaching for it, picked up by Rafkin as time winds down. In comes Kapanen, works in and shoots, and Grant punches that away, rebound, and Liukas couldn't get to it. Time expires here at the end of the opening period, and Canada goes to the dressing room with a 1-0 lead on the goal by Joshua Waugh. You're watching the gold medal game from the 2022 World Junior Hockey Championship Summer Edition. Our first intermission with James Duffy, Cheryl Pounder, Bob McKenzie, and Jeff O'Neill is coming up from Edmonton.
Very entertaining first period in Edmonton. The number one pick in the 2019 Quebec League draft, the 150th pick in the 2021 NHL draft to Montreal, Joshua Waugh has the lone goal for Canada over Finland. He's with Tessa Benham.
Josh, the game where you want to be, lots of nerves, excitement, I'm sure. What's it like playing in finally an almost packed house here in Edmonton?
Well, it's incredible. As a hockey player, we want to play for those games, and today we are here, and crowd is crazy, so it's unbelievable.
I can only imagine what it was like when you scored your goal. Walk me through what took place. You started it and finished it after all.
Yeah, the key today is throw the puck and chase, and that's what I did. And Mac took the puck and shot, and I got the open net, so I put it in. That was pretty crazy.
Your line was labeled the checking line. Seems like checking was working just fine. Is that the game plan coming in, was to really put pressure on their D?
Yeah, exactly. Just put pressure in the D, and they're good when they have time, and when they don't, they're not very, so we're trying to do that.
Best of luck the rest of the way.
Thank you.
All right, back with Cheryl Pounder, Jeff O'Neill, and Bob McKenzie. After sitting through an entire tournament here in 2021 with no fans in the bubble, and then sitting through this tournament with not very many fans for most of the games, it's great to have a mostly packed house here. It feels like a gold medal game, and you felt it on that goal, the usual suspect leading to it?
Absolutely. Perfectly executed by the Canadians, and the way the Finns are stacking up in the neutral zone, they have no choice but to dump the puck in and get after it. There's nothing exciting available through the neutral zone. And it's perfectly executed by Joshua Waugh right here. His job right now is man on body and loosen that puck up and then go right to the front of the net after that. Mason McTavish gets the puck up. The Finnish defender is trying to play goalie there. That's a tough position to put himself in, and the goaltender, and Joshua Waugh has an open net. But that's what's available, and it's perfectly executed right there.
We mentioned Mason McTavish decided to come back to this tournament when a lot of guys headed to NHL camps did not want to, chasing that gold medal. He's also chasing history. Gord mentioned it. Now just two goals shy of the all-time Canadian single tournament goal record, which is shared by Dale McCourt and Josh Anderson, and 2 points off the all-time Canadian points record shared by McCourt and Braden Schenn. Two periods left to do it. I'm sure the furthest thing from his mind right now, gold, the first thing.
As Jeff pointed out on that first goal by Team Canada, the absolute key to beating Finland is puck management through the neutral zone. The Finns will stack either three forwards across the center ice red line, two on the blue line, or move a forward back, stack three on the blue line. So what do they want to do? They want to post forwards up, they want to tip pucks behind the defense, and then get in on the forecheck. That was opening face-off of the game. Perfectly executed to what they want to do. That way they know they're not playing in their end. And again, just a little chip play through the neutral zone. Make sure the puck gets behind the Finnish defense. Go in and go to work on the forecheck and make something happen. You can carry through the neutral zone, but you've got to be careful. A guy like Kent Johnson's a great skater. He can weave by all those flat-footed defensemen. Same thing again. Come through the neutral zone with speed. Go by. Hit the center red line. Get the puck deep. And ensure that you're not playing in your end. Look at the great opportunity created by another dump in from the guy who got the first goal. That is precisely the way Dave Cameron wants them to play, and it was executed really well, especially in the first 10 or 12 minutes.
You know, the Finns winning their last game 1-0, they're quite comfortable doing that. They do not want to go up and down the ice with the Canadians, so they're just sitting back saying, try that one cross-ice pass and we'll make you pay. You can just see them sitting and waiting for that.
The guys talked about the comments by Finnish coach Antti Pennanen last night, saying that Canada isn't very good in their defensive end. First of all, one of the things I love about this tournament is the Europeans are always giving us quotes like that. They're far more open than we see covering hockey in North America. But they had issues, Canada, in their defensive end. What have they done to shore it up so far through 20?
Well, they haven't been in their zone, in particular in the first 12 minutes of that game where Finland wasn't able to get a shot on net. And this was because they were steering the play. The Finns love to get to the middle of the ice, and Canada was closing it down and shutting down the neutral zone. You can see right here, they want to push to one side of the ice. They do not want them to track up the middle, and this is why they're pushing to the one side. You can just see, as you can't see the guys in your screen, but they are pushing this Finnish defender to the outside. He's making them wait, and then all of a sudden they're pouncing on it. They're steering and influencing the play to the outside, and now you can attack and force the dump, and this is exactly what Canada wants. Now, also reading through the rush, the ability to close in the neutral zone when you read the numbers to be able to retrieve. Again, influencing and then being there to retrieve it, showing your body, playing physical, adding that element to the game, but when you don't allow speed, you don't allow entry, and that's something that Canada did very, very well.
We know some of you are watching this gold medal game. It's your first game you're watching in the tournament. Early on, it was all about Connor Bedard and Mason McTavish. They were the top line. They were doing spectacular things. The Logan Stankoven line was fairly quiet. Then when Ridley Gregg got hurt, McTavish was moved to a checking line, Bedard to a different line, and the Stankoven line became the key offensive line. And just like the semis, though, does it feel like every time on the ice they're doing something?
Exactly. When the Finnish coach made those comments about the defensive zone, he certainly wasn't referring to this line, because all they do is get in on the forecheck and cycle. They're never in their zone. And when you have a team that's playing defensive-minded like the Finns are right now, you need a line to get out there and really cycle. And what you got to do is tire out some defensemen so then they can make some mistakes in the corner. And every time these guys, they have so much good chemistry right now, every time they're on the ice, the low cycle is where it's at for these guys. They understand that, and that's where they're putting the puck.
Well, and they're always connected, oh. They're always connected. They're always moving. And that motion makes it so difficult to fend against them. And then you've got the quick, quick hands of Johnson, the ability to just open up a lane a fraction of a second. But when you have close support, you have the ability to retrieve the puck. And they're finding lanes all over the ice, and the puck pursuit is tremendous.
We have so many goalie analysts. They always tell me that the hardest part is to sit through a game and not have any action. And Grand had hardly any through the first half of that period. But when he was forced in the second, how would you evaluate his game?
Very, very well. And I mean, here's my math skills at work. It was 8-2 shots on goal for Canada. It ended up 10-9 in favor of Canada. That means in the last third of the period, the Finns outshot Canada by a 7-2 margin. So Dylan Garand really started to have to make some saves. And MJ was talking off the top about he hasn't had to be in the heat of battle because Team Canada's been playing with significant leads most of the time. But that was a pressure-packed period where Dylan Garand stood tall, made the saves that he needed to, and ensured he kept that zero on the board for Team Canada.
12 minutes without a shot, and then getting it and being that effective late in the period. Excellent.
See if it carries in to the second period of play. We have a bronze medalist, Team Sweden, over Team Czechia earlier on today. If you missed that one, we'll bring you the highlights. Sweden had their golden dreams dashed again. Only one gold medal in 43 years, but they were able to get back up for this one. The details right after this from the World Juniors in Edmonton. As soon as this tournament is done, we will turn our attention to the Women's World Championship in Denmark. Team Canada trying to defend the title it won last year here in Alberta. August 25th to September 4th, Canada opens up on the 25th against Finland. As promised, the bronze medal game from earlier today, the Battle of the Brokenhearted, Sweden and Czechia, the two teams with the worst records in bronze medals at the World Juniors. They combined 3-12. Tough to get up for those bronze medal games sometimes. Opening period, Fabian Liesel beats the Czechia defender to the puck, and on the wraparound, a beauty of a goal. We didn't see enough of this from Sweden in the tournament. They're up 1-0 after one in the second. Czechia ties it, but 2 minutes later off the faceoff, Sabres first rounder Isaac Rosen scores his fourth of the tournament. Just like that, Sweden up 2-1. Souvenir to the third period, still with that lead, another Sabres pick. Linus Sjödin streaking in, and he gives the Swedes a two-goal lead, and that would be enough. His first point of the tournament, that is timely. Sweden picks up its third ever World Junior bronze, third medal in 5 years, as they win it 3-1 over Czechia. Good run by the Czechs. They had finished seventh three straight times at the World Juniors. That upset over the U.S. at least gets them to the semifinals. Canada up 1-0, second just ahead. Our friends at Sport Logic continuing to track those dangerous slot shots. 7 for Canada, only 1 for Finland. Consider this, the Finns did not give up a single slot shot in the semis against Sweden last night. Canada gets 7 and the 1 goal to lead. Your scoring summary, McTavish with the assist. He now has a 5-point lead on the Finns, Joachim Kemmel for the tournament scoring lead. So that one almost a lock. Gordon Mike in the second.
All right, James, so we've talked that pre-game about what Canada had to do. What did you see in the first period that you liked?
If Canada's going to win this game, it's going to come down to one thing. How well they can break the puck out of their own end. How clean they can be in passing it, skating it up the ice. When they're clean, they will dominate territory. They will have the puck in the offensive zone, and their skill will come flying through. And when they had several instances of these clean plays, you saw them create that speed and that tempo up the ice. In Finland, as good as they are defensively, don't like that. And then that clean breakout then starts the forecheck. And forecheck caused problems for Finland as well. And you're physical, they make mistakes, they turn pucks over, ended up resulting in the one goal by Joshua Roy. All because of clean breakouts, strong forechecks. If they can do that consistently, they'll be in great shape to win this game.
James will start the second period, 5-on-5. There were no penalties in the first. A stop check. Plays it back around for Sabrango. That lead pass chipped in by McTavish. The tournament point leader goes after it. McTavish fought hard to play for this Canadian junior team. He'll be heading to Anaheim's training camp quickly. Waugh plays it back across. McTavish is also an 0-3 born. He could play at Christmas if he were made available. That seems unlikely.
Sure, Anaheim's going to want to release him.
McTavish back on it. Scored in his first NHL game for the Ducks last year. And now Zellweger. Shoved down Simon Taibo. Drops it back for DeFore. DeFore in shoot score! DeFore, 41 seconds into the second period, makes it 2-0.
The 56 goal scoring checking winger shows that shot. Starts with a defensive zone play here and a little shove in the back by Zellweger, which will draw the ire of the Finnish fans. But there's Zellweger driving the middle, pushing the defense back because he did not put the puck to the wing too early. Waiting till he gets to the blue line, then kicks it over and drag, pull, change the angle. And what a shot from DeFore past Jatkala. And I think this is going to be a timeout.
It is. The Finns
of Finland right away, 41 seconds into the second period, trying to settle things down on the Finnish bench.
We mentioned DeFore trying to become the 25th player to win the Memorial Cup and the World Junior in the same year. He didn't just win the Memorial Cup. He was the MVP, scoring 7 goals in 4 games. That's one off the tournament record that was set by Dale Hawerchuk, Luke Robitaille, and Pat Falloon.
He's got that shot, though. I mean, you see why he scores so many goals. Big body, long reach, but he can really shoot it.
And Islanders' fifth rounder, so now a 2-goal cushion for Canada, and the Finns have used their timeout. Simon Taiva moves it back ahead through the middle, knocked away from Thompson as Jarvetti goes after him. Back after it, Kent Johnson puts it high in the air. Jarvetti's dad played against Art Jeff O'Neill in the 1995 World Junior Championship.
A long time pro over in Europe as well. And Zellweger is just piling up the points of this tournament now. A little shove in the back that knocks over Hirvonen and that sets up the rush opportunity. And then Zellweger's off the races. It's a bit of a 3-on-3 because Ratu is back, but you see how Zellweger with his speed pushed both defensemen back, which allowed DeFore the time and space for the drag release.
Now picked up by Del Mastro. Ethan Del Mastro spins back away from Väisänen. Plays it back around to Cormier. And Lucas Cormier winds his way out. Oh, plays it off Bedard's helmet and back down to the finish zone. Cooley got spun around as he tried to knock down Viro. Oh, big hit missed there by Bedard, just on Kapanen. And Bedard has not been afraid to throw his weight around here, such as it is, in this tournament.
Well, a lot of people have taken a little run, little shots at Bedard, so he's giving them back whenever he can't.
Masali fires that back down the Canadian zone, waiting for his Zellweger. Up for a stop check. Out to center ice, Hoffman tried to play that back across, but broken up. By Mattis, we got a penalty now coming. It's going against Finland for a high stick, and Canada gets the game's first power play as Ruben Rafkin gets called for the high stick.
Team Finland, play number 3, minor penalty, boarding.
Boarding?
Boarding. Drove his head in the glass up top. I thought the stick came across his face. It did. Hoffman reacted to the slash. So Canada back to the power play, looking to their third as DeFore with the beautiful look at his release. And Mom, Kareen, can barely contain herself. Oh my goodness. What are you gonna say? What are you gonna say? It's my boy.
The two of them are very close. While the Quebec League was shut down, he was able to drive her to treatments. She was diagnosed with cancer. And they're super, super close. And DeFore has talked about the impact she's had on him. And now Canada on the power play. 8-for-14 on the man advantage of the tournament. Johnson down to McTavish. 7 different players have scored power play goals. Johnson shoots. Turned away by Yakovlev. Bouncing puck in front. Still loose. Picked up by Johnson. Here's Bedard back with it. Honor Bedard. Feeds that back to Zellweger for Stankoven. Back to Zellweger for Johnson. Kent Johnson. Winds that down to McTavish, moves to the front of the goal. McTavish walks in, waits, trying to find the stick of Johnson, taps it back across, that's knocked out by Miro.
That is some creativity down in front of the net by Kent Johnson.
Now the puck at his feet, got bumped there by Mata, and Mata lifts it back down to the Canadian zone where Garan gloves it. Zellweger moves it back across, pokes that in for Johnson. Winding his way in, Kent Johnson drops it back. Here's McTavish, steps around Kapanen, drops it off to Stankoven. Logan Stankoven feeds that back to Johnson, now back at the point for Zellweger. Zellweger to McTavish. McTavish back to Johnson, works it across. Here's McTavish, handle that pass, sends it rink wide. Stankoven had that handcuff him. Now Johnson misfires on it. McTavish had to slap that back across, gets taken down and drops it back to Johnson. 30 seconds to go in this Canadian power play. Johnson to McTavish. Walks right back in front. Yakovlev saved point blank. And the rebound cleared down the ice by Yermo. Zellweger back to pick it up with 20 seconds to go on the Canadian man advantage. And fresh legs coming on. Zellweger drops it off to Cooley for Forster. Tyson Forster works in. It was knocked away by Puglio. And the puck comes back to center ice. Three shots for Canada on that power play. Remains a 2-0 game. In comes Wah. Joshua Wah in. Backhand of that wide. Cooley comes in. That was knocked by him. It rolls right down to Garand out to play it. He knocked that away from Raskin, who was out of the penalty box. Raskin takes a run there at Sealy. Hirvonen. The Finnish captain, the Toronto Maple Leafs pick, drops it back for Mata. And it gets by Niemela back down to the Finnish zone. Niemela. Long pass in for Järventi. Järventi. Pumped there by Sealy, stays on it, drops that back to Niemela. Sees it up and shoots. That goes just wide through a forest of legs. Simon Teibel down low. Plays it back for Mata. Being watched there by Hoffman. Feeds it back for Niemela, who loves to shoot. Does again and puts it wide. Mata. Back for Yermo. Niemela swings it back across to Mata. The matchup by Niemela goes off a stick and into the corner for Cormier. Tired players on the ice now for Canada. They've been hemmed in a bit here. Simon Teibel works it back in front. Intercepted by Sealy, but kept alive by Mata. Here they come again. Mata sends it back in front. Garland makes a great stop on the deflection and is able to hang on.
You're right. It's a disjointed change at the end of a power play. Guys who don't always play out there together get running around their own end for a little while, and Garand bails out the team, not only making the save, but importantly freezing the puck for a rebound. He understands what's happening out there. His team needs a change badly. And he gets the whistle that they needed. One of the first extended sequences in the offensive zone for Finland, certainly in this period.
Dylan Garand played sparingly in the 2021 tournament with Canada with a silver medal. Losing the gold medal game here in this building in the bubble. And credit to the Edmonton organizers, they agreed to stage that tournament in the bubble. And then when this was rescheduled due to COVID, came back in the summer to make sure that the players from all 10 countries, especially those born in 02 who were in their last year of eligibility, got a chance to play in the World Junior Championship. Now picked up at the side of the goal by Wah. Centers it for McTavish. He kicked that wide. And here's Vero back with it. Both teams changing. Amosomi up ahead for Ratu. The Islander draft pick back across for Hirvonen. And in shoots and fires that wide. Now it skips by Niemela back down to the finish zone. And Stankoven on his horse gets there first. Stankoven. Try to center it, knocked away and brought back by Ratu. 2-on-1 for the Finns as they hurry. Ratu works in, back in front for Hirvonen, put that wide. Here's Ratu back with it. Drops that back. And Rafkin's shot was blocked, picked up by Stankoven. Lead pass, here comes Johnson on the breakaway. Dave Johnson shoots, and a save made. Rebound goes back to Zellweger. Zellweger plays it across. Stankoven a one-time chance, and Jakula makes the stop. Sealy, back down to Johnson. And Johnson works it free. This line goes back to work. For all the changes that have been made, this has been consistent for Canada. And productive. Ratu winds in as the Finns are changing. Being watched there by Sealy. Then Forster comes in to help out. Cormier has two Finns converging on him. Made the play. Stankoven up ahead to Hoffman. And Brennan Hoffman, the native of Pickering, Ontario, plays it in. Hoffman centers it. And just missed on that. NYA on the forecheck. Not permanent off the puck. NYA causing the Finns all kinds of problems. Now Yermo with a lead pass to Puglio. He spins back in the corner. Puglio tied up. NYA with it. Tried to poke that by Covenant. And Puglio back on it. Picked up by Cormier on his backhand. Looks like ahead to Osmond, but it's knocked away. And Big Hellenius is back on it. Amosomi works it in, shoots it, goes off a stick, pinballs around in front. And a stop check waiting for it, couldn't clear it out. And again, Canada getting hemmed in here in the second period.
Let's give some credit. They get on the forecheck, they're effective that way as well.
Del Mastro trying to clear it out. That's knocked down. In comes Vero. Emil Vero shoots. That's blocked by Cormier. Again, knocked down on the clearing attempt. Played back, Amosomi works it in, shoots, that goes wide, off the end, boards, Garand down, he squeezes against the post, and he's got it. William DeFore, Memorial Cup champion for St. John, looks to make it a double in 2022. He's got the 2-0 goal for Canada in the gold medal game at the World Junior Hockey Championship.
Canada up 2-0. Kent Johnson trying to make it 3. He hit an incredible semifinal game, and as soon as he sees the turnover, he blows his own, and that's a nice lead pass from Stankoven. And he's looking to drag and got to get it above the glove. But a good save, and maybe game-saving save by Jatkala. Wow. They go down 3-0 at this point. First one, he just can't quite grab the rebound either. And the bench sees him. He's in. They know he's in. Here we go. They want it so badly for him. He just couldn't quite find a way. And then the other end, ooh, that puck is dribbling back out. Durand calmly seals it against the side of the net. Make sure not to drag that one in yourself.
So the face-off in the Canadian zone. It'll be Nathan Gauthier who takes the draw. Anaheim first-round pick in 2022. Here's Seeley. Back across to Cooley. And Will Cooley fires that down to the finish zone. Jakob has to play it, lost it. Gauthier almost had a chance at the side of the goal. Now Gauthier goes in on the Niemela. And the Niemela plays that to an open wing where Jarventie swings that back for Rafkin. Rafkin for Jarventie. Jarventie works in. Backhand shot. Deflects wide. Simon Teibel with it. Kasper Simon Teibel lost that puck to Gauthier, and Bedard has it back. Bedard. Great play to wind away from two Finnish forecheckers. Now moves it back to center ice. In comes Connor Bedard. Penalty coming now as he got hurt. And Jarmo touches up, and Connor Bedard forces the Finns into a penalty. And Canada's going back on the power play.
It's an involved shift for Connor Bedard. He got all tangled up with Mata earlier in the shift. No penalty on either side.
Team Finland, number 27, minor penalty, holding.
And here, Bedard gets a stick kind of up and around Mata. He doesn't like it. He gets the elbow for his trouble. It could have been no penalty or two penalties on that one. But then the ability to rush it up on his own. Celia dropped the stick. He gets his own clear and an entry, and Kapanen reaches and wraps. Let's see if Canada, last power play was very effective. Not a goal, but lots of different looks.
Three shots on it.
If they can find a way to get one past Jakula.
Mata wins that face-off back, and Puccio sends it down the ice. Durand almost turned that over to Bison. And here is Zellweger with it. Olin Zellweger. Plays for Everett in the Western Hockey League. Drops it back to the Regina superstar, Connor Bedard. McTavish plays it back around to Stankoven. Logan Stankoven. Back down to Berard. That skipped away. McTavish looking for it. The puck cleared down the ice by Niemela. Durand. Long lead pass to Johnson with the Finns changing. He finds McTavish. McTavish works in. Taken down. And he slides into Jatkala.
Good decision by Garand. A lot of the times I don't love that quick up because it ends up passing the puck up to someone standing still by themselves, but Johnson has support. McTavish goes with a feather off, slide it underneath the stick and try to attack the net. And boy, did he ever attack the net. Crashing into Jakula. The referees right now are getting together, deciding where this face-off goes, whether it goes inside or outside the blue line. They're going to put it outside because McTavish is looking to add to this very lofty group.
The court in the first World Junior Championship in 1977, Braden Schenn in 2011 in Buffalo, Gretzky in the 1978 tournament in Montreal, and Eric Lindros in Saskatoon in 91.
Wow. That is some, those are some names.
Yeah.
It'd be a lot worse to be in any kind of group with those guys.
With 20 goals in 29 games in junior this year between Peterborough and Hamilton, played the Memorial Cup and the Olympics. Back at the point is Johnson. To McTavish. Bedard was knocked down in front. Now Johnson back with it. McTavish pulls it back. Shoots to put that wide. Well, between the legs shot there. Stankoven. Back to Bedard. For McTavish. To Johnson. Johnson swings that back to Zellweger. Zellweger to Stankoven. Back to Zellweger. Wrist shot. Tipped to wide by Bedard. Stankoven. Back to Zellweger. Crossy goes to Johnson. 45 seconds to go on the power play. Zellweger holds the line. Works it across. Johnson pivots around. Drops it off to McTavish. Mason McTavish directing traffic. Drops it back to Zellweger. To Stankoven. For the goal mouth, there's Johnson trying to pull it back across. Zellweger feeds it from McTavish. A hard shot. Rebound loose in front. And Johnson couldn't reach that. McTavish back with it. For Johnson. Back to Zellweger. Johnson slap pass across. Stankoven shoots. It's tipped away by Rafkin. Johnson back with it. Tired finish, penalty killers on the ice now. Here's Johnson, a one-time shot that was off the mask of Yakima.
Maybe the hardest I've ever seen Kent Johnson shoot a puck that one-timer right there.
Zellweger back across to Johnson. Final seconds of the power play. Johnson drops it back. Bedard, a hard shot. He ripped that wide. Bouncing puck in the side of the goal. Knocked down by Rafkin. They think it's in.
No. What happened? Puck was on top of the net. It was coming back over. I think Yakula sealed it with his shoulder, but a Finnish player put his hand on top of the puck, on top of the net, and the referee likely making a call here. What a sequence. Crazy pressure by Canada.
The power play doesn't click, but comes close right there. It's the prequel to the groundbreaking Game of Thrones, House of the Dragon, an HBO original series, streams tomorrow, and you can only watch it on Crave.
What a wild sequence around the net, and Rafkin goes right back to the box as this heavy shot. The first one is chipped out of the air here, poked in, but that secondary seal by Yakula was incredible. Then Rafkin just ill-advisedly just grabs the puck, but Yakula to have the wherewithal to get his neck basically and back of the head up against, if he doesn't do that,
right,
puck rolls down his back and into the net. Now it probably wouldn't have counted because Johnson jimmied it off the back. He thought it was going in, and then Rafkin, I don't know what he's thinking. He can't just pick it up and run away with it. So I'm not sure, this probably would have been high stick here on Kent Johnson, but nonetheless, incredible by Yakula.
Third straight power play to Canada.
At some point, you got to get one because you know Finland's got to get a power play this game.
No shots on the last one. Stankoven pokes that back to Zellweger and keeps it alive for McTavish. McTavish back to Johnson. This top group back out there. Kent Johnson in for Bedard. Tip that wide. Johnson slides it back to Bedard. Bedard waits, shoots short side, and Yakula's got it on Connor Bedard.
Yeah, Bedard's a great shooter, but that's not a great shot. Selection. As they're a little bit out of their set, and nobody was really around in front. And, he wants to try to make something happen here, but when there's nobody around in front, that shot is unlikely to go in, even when you can shoot it the way Bedard can. He's trying to get his touches. He's in the bumper there, so he's being a decoy a lot on the power play.
Bedard slides that back to Johnson. Bedard can't quite hold the line as Canada tags back up. Bedard works it across the line, drops it off to Johnson. And Kent Johnson winds in. To McTavish. Back to Zellweger. Across he goes to Stankoven. Logan Stankoven drops that down to Johnson. Johnson puts it back to McTavish. And McTavish, well, that pass is picked off and brought off by Kapanen, shorthanded. Kapanen works it on Zellweger. Stays on it. And now McTavish picks up the loose puck, and he'll wind ahead. Kapanen trapped in deep in the Canadian zone as McTavish winds in with Bedard. Drops it back to Johnson. Feeds that back to Zellweger. Works it and shoots. Passes puck around. Bedard with a chance. Still loose in front. Stankoven reaching for it. Yakula down. Makes a pad save. Chopped the line, and Zellweger holds it. Zellweger back across to Johnson. 40 seconds to go on the power play. McTavish to Johnson. Johnson back to Zellweger. Winds it across. Johnson walks right over the puck. Rolled off his stick, and Kapanen plays it out.
Yakula has gotten busy on these power plays.
Finland shorthanded for the third time in this period. And the lead pass goes to Waugh. Scored the opening goal for Canada. Waugh spins back. Thompson's moved up. It's banked by him and back down the ice. Final seconds now on the power play.
So put Thompson out there instead of Seeley, because with the penalty expires, they want a normal pair out there defending.
Two shots for Canada on that power play. Remains a 2-0 game as Forster winds in. Tyson Forster. Crunch in the corner by Vaisanen. Stays on it. Going to work that free for Hoffman, and does. Hoffman. Back of the point, he goes to Cormier, across to Thompson. Shoots, tipped in front, Yekla makes the save. Forster back to Cormier, he fires, that goes wide. Now Thompson shoots, Yekla the stop on that, and the shot's piling up here. Wall was shoved in to the finished goal, now it's brought back out by Vero. And meantime, as all this is going on, the top Finnish offensive players have been stapled to the bench because they don't kill penalties. Cormier, rink wide for Denoyer. Denoyer spins it in and plays that back down in the finish zone. Ostapchuk seals the wall, got knocked off the puck by Jarvinti. Niemela. Or Yermo. Batted down. Ratu looking for the bouncy puck, picked up by Ostapchuk. Zach Ostapchuk. It was seen. Albert Alberta just outside Edmonton plays it in. But the play is called as Denoyer is into it with Joni Yermo.
Yeah, but fixing up the helmet as he has been busy with shots and bodies. Now, if you push the offensive player into the net, don't be upset when he falls into your goalie when you cross-check him from behind in there. Good job by the officials not reacting to it, even though there's been a run of penalties to Finland.
Face-off was won by Kapanen. Waiting for it is Vero. Plays it back down to Liukas as Sabrango steps into him. Ostapchuk going to dig that free, and does. He got bumped by Kemmel behind the goal. Joachim Kemmel causing all kinds of problems. Ostapchuk once again on it. Seeley works out to the corner, and Ostapchuk gathers it back up. That's a field linesman. And Ostapchuk trying to work it free again, does for Cooley. Took a while, but Canada finally gets it out. Cooley
another
dumps it
icing.
In.
That is
another icing.
Soft play.
An unforced error for Canada brings the faceoff back down to their zone.
Yeah, and Canada will complain about the officials. Doesn't matter. Cooley's still 3 feet from the red line. He's got to find a way to make a soft chip or get it. As this line has now been out there for quite a while, and the number one unit that is well rested, ready to go for Finland.
Scramble draw goes back to Rafkin in, shoots, and Grant makes the glove save. And he'll hold that. On the final day, it looks, sounds, and feels like a gold medal game at the World Junior Championship. Canada, 2-0 lead here in the second period. The biggest stars in women's hockey, Kendall Coyne Schofield, Hillary Knight from the U.S. heading to Denmark. Captain Clutch, Riefli Poulin. All headed there for the Women's World Championship. Coverage begins next week. Kenzie Lalonde and Cheryl Pounder will lead our coverage. Cheryl's been here for a couple weeks and is heading to Denmark, I think, on Tuesday.
My new favorite women's player, Sarah Filliet, is just dynamo young star in the making for Canada. Yeah, so.
Three tournaments in August. It started with Holinka Gretzky and Red Deer a couple weeks ago. The rescheduled World Junior Championship here, and then the Women's World Championship as scheduled in Denmark. The first time there'll be a Women's World Championship the same year as the Olympics. And there is Luke Tardif, the IHF president. We should point out that with this tournament being completed, the Women's World Championship, and three more tournaments to be held in September, the IHF will get all 33 events in that schedule in all divisions for men and women completed. So all players in all divisions got to play in their tournaments. That's a Herculean feat given the challenges of the pandemic and the finances involved. Hirvonen works in, holds. Looking for Ratu, and Zellweger knocks that away. Rafkin, rush it back across. Hirvonen shot that pinballed wide. Picked up by Niemela. Puppy Niemela. Wrists it back down. Zellweger pokes at it, and Dufour got cold there. And the penalty coming to Finland again. Dufour takes a high stick in the face.
Trying to get some blood out of that mouth. Lose a tooth or something. Oh, he might have lost a bit of a bottom tooth. Ratu heads the box.
It's going to be a two-minute minor.
Not quite enough to draw a four.
Finland number 34, 2 minutes, high sticking.
So in the IHF, they focus less on the result and more on the act. In the NHL, if you're injured...
Right. And the language in the NHL is injured, not blood, so we can be injured in different ways, but that's not a fall through. That's Ratu trying to jump over top of an oncoming hit and gets his stick up into the face of Dufour. Now, this is the fourth penalty in a row for Finland, which means Canada's playing discipline, drawing penalties, creating chances in the power play. But at some point, you know you're going to get a penalty if you're Canada. So you got to bear down and try to convert here, take advantage of the man advantage.
Chase off one by Kapanen, set down the ice. Canada 0 for 3 on the power play, 5 shots total. And here is Zellweger, the power play quarterback. Drops that back to McTavish, the captain. Steams through center ice, native of Carp, Ontario. Drops that back to Johnson. McTavish, the puck to the end boards. Here's Bedard, back for Johnson. For Zellweger. Zellweger, to Stankoven. Back to Zellweger, Johnson. Elects not to shoot, bounces off his stick, he plays it back to McTavish. Snaps that pass back for Zellweger, but it was out of his reach and back down to the Canadian zone. If added an assist on the Dufour goal to McTavish, so that's 17 points
in the defensive zone before the rush started. So
now one away from tying the Canadian record. Here he comes again. McTavish shoots, goes off the stick of Väisänen, bounces back to Stankoven. Stankoven, lots of motion here on the power play. Back at the point it goes to Zellweger, across to Johnson, slaps that diagonally for Stankoven. To Zellweger, 45 seconds to go on the power play. Johnson, a one-time shot. Great save there by Jakula.
Guys down on the net, got to get their sticks down on the ice. McTavish and Bedard.
Johnson, back to McTavish. Swings that back to Zellweger. Zellweger to McTavish, a hard shot. Jakula save, and he'll pounce on the rebound. And Bedard was there looking for any loose change.
A good read by Jakula, though. We've seen McTavish score a couple times on that one-timer. But this time you see going up and down over to Johnson, and both McTavish and Bedard have their stick about knee height, and the puck skips past them. You get it down to the ground, maybe it might hit the blade, and a good read by Jakula to get to the spot before the pass does, able to stay upright to take the top of the net away on the one-timer.
Cooley wins the face-off back to Forrester. Cormier plays it back. Rafkin knocked down Watt. And Cormier plays it back across the ceiling. Cormier swings that back. Roman Seeley works it back across for Cooley. That bounced away from him. Cooley taking down a chance now for Mata. Joel Mata works in. Final seconds of the power play. Mata just swings back and takes them off. Two shots in that power play for Canada. It's still a 2-0 game. And Yermo back with it. Mayenpaa. Sealed off by Forrester. Banks that back down to the Canadian zone. Seeley back after it. And racing to it is Mayenpaa. A stop check. Plays that behind the goal. And Seeley finds Othman. Back at the finish line. Jarmo plays that away. And the puck bounces back to Seeley. Crossy goes to Cormier. Lucas Cormier. Drops that back. And the pass ahead for Dufour is held by Carpenter. Dufour plays it back up to center ice. Picked up by Yermo, the Vancouver third round pick. Swings that back across. And played in by Putio. It skips down to Garand, and he'll hang on to that.
Communication there. Cormier letting Garand know to hold it, hold it, hold it. And they were late in the shift, both Seeley and Cormier. They don't want to be forced to play the defensive zone any longer than they had to, so good decision by Grand. He's getting a little nervous with those dirty bouncers heading in, the Super Bowl effect.
The ice has held up pretty well here.
It certainly has.
Given the temperature outside, it's been spectacular weather. I'm from here.
It's the best weather I've had all summer. It's been amazing.
Never seen it like this. I mean, it's just been spectacular every day. Vero works around Wall. Emil Vero drops that back. Hirvonen shoots. That goes off the leg of Thompson. Hirvonen spins out of the corner with it. Pumped there by Sabrango. And DeFore comes in as well. Now Ratu back with it. Final minute of the second period. Ratu tied up there by Waugh. The puck loose for DeFore. Puts it high in the air for McTavish. Face of McTavish. Gets in. McTavish is back in. Rolled off his stick. And a penalty coming.
That's got to be.
Penalty shot? Yes.
Got to be.
They're pointing to center ice. They pointed to center ice at first.
I didn't see the X.
He did not give the X initially. That's referee Sean Fernandez.
Finland number 6, 2 minutes slashing.
So it's a slashing call, not a penalty shot. He initially pointed to center ice.
I guess he'd say he was pointing towards the penalty box, but
right.
It looked to me like McTavish, a little nice little flipper there. McTavish shows some pretty good wheels. Are you telling me he's not in alone there? Like, what does in alone mean? McTavish, should we sometimes say, how fast is he? Well, I don't know. I see him skating past defenders. He's pretty clear in alone, but nonetheless, another power play.
Five
in a row to Canada.
This will be Cooley with Forster and Law up front. And the two defensemen, Seeley and Cormier in the back end. Joshua Law is one of the two Canadian goals. Works it back across. That's back wide by Cormier. Seeley drops it back to Law. Waugh for Cormier, walks in, fans on the shot, and Bisonen plays it back out. Cormier drops that back to Cooley, and Will Cooley, the Rangers second rounder, takes that pass back from Forster, slides it back across to Cormier, in for Waugh, centering pass, Forster missed on that, and set down the ice by Liukas. Time expires at the end of the second period. Canada will have a minute and 14 seconds of power play time to carry over into the third period. It's a 2-0 lead in the gold medal game of the 2022 World Junior Hockey Championship, Summer Edition. Our second intermission with James Duffy, Cheryl Pounder, Bob McKenzie, and the O-Dog, Jeff O'Neill, is coming up.
Here is your second intermission at the World Junior Hockey Championship. Canada with 9 minutes of power play time and still more to start the third, but still that 2-0 lead here in the gold medal game from Edmonton. James Duffy back with Cheryl Pounder, Jeff O'Neill, and Bob McKenzie. Here's a heartwarming feel-good story. The IIHF felt so sorry for Jeff O'Neill after he lost his gold medal in Vancouver a few years ago. They've given him the trophy. Jeff, this is now yours after it's presented today. No, it won't. It won't be yours.
No.
You don't get a day with it. Don't touch
you do,
it.
I want to come.
Don't touch it.
Hey, at least put 1995 on that.
Well, spin it around so you're on there somewhere.
You told me not to touch. I'm not touching it because I'll get in trouble.
He was asking why his name isn't on it earlier. They don't put the names, Jeff. They just put the country names. Let's start with what happened at the end of the period there. And Mason McTavish, they call a penalty. Do you think it should have been a penalty shot?
I absolutely think that's a penalty shot just because of the standard nowadays in any league and what's being handed out as a penalty shot. That, to me, looks like he's in alone, the slash on the hands. A lot less than that, whether it be junior hockey, the National Hockey League, that has been awarded a penalty shot. Therefore, it should have been called right there.
And I disagree with you, because I don't actually think by the time he gets on it, look where he is at the hash marks. He's got two guys right on him. So I don't actually think he's in the clear.
It's almost like he didn't have control of it. He was almost losing control before he got to it. I didn't think it was a penalty shot either.
But the argument as a forward is because I got slashed and people were bothering me, that's why I lost control of the puck. I honestly think that was a penalty shot.
Right.
You've seen it called all year.
We try to develop all these storylines coming in based on statistics, and we can throw them all out today. Because remember, coming in, Finland had 26 power play opportunities to lead the tournament. Canada only had 14, and yet it's 5-0 for Canada so far. So credit Canada dominating play and discipline. The other thing was Canada had the best power play in the tournament. Finland had the worst penalty kill, and yet the Finns have killed 4.5 so far. Did you feel like the Canadian power play kind of got worse as it went along?
Well, they did have some real good opportunities at the start of the period, James, but that was their chance to ice this game and put it away. They did have a ton of opportunities. They did have possession. They had their key guys out there. They even had the gift of the TV timeout where I was thinking the coach should call a timeout, but they were handed one. They had all these opportunities down low. and they were moving the puck around. They created shots. The one thing I would like to see is a bit of an adjustment. It seemed like Connor Bedard is standing around a lot in that bumper position and not getting a lot of touches or a lot of shots. So that's the one adjustment I would make moving into the third period. Just move him around a little bit so we get some more touches and some more plays at the net.
Yeah, 9+ minutes of power play time in that period alone. And it almost becomes a momentum sapping thing for Team Canada. There's so many players sitting on the bench. There's so few players that are playing. The ones that are playing may be getting a little frustrated because they're not making anything happen. Now, some credit to the goaltender, Jatkala. When it was 5-on-5, he ends up making an absolutely brilliant save on Ken Johnson. Ken Johnson, one of the elite offensive players for Team Canada, gets a clean-cut breakaway, and Jatkala comes up big with the save right there. And then back on the power play, we get one more look at the Johnson power play. Even strength breakaway. Great save there. And this play on the power play, Mike Johnson referred to it. That was a game saver, right? Potential game saver right there, where he uses the back of his neck to seal the deal against the crossbar so that it doesn't hit his back and go into the net. So it'll be interesting. 1:14 of power play time for Team Canada to start the third period. Otherwise, they've got to get refocused and reestablished. So many guys got cold in that period.
Yeah, and DeFore is one of them as well. He didn't play on the power play. I mean, he's got 116 points in the queue, and he's not getting any time there as well. So they have to get some much-needed momentum back, and they have to dictate pace right off the hop here. This is a two-goal game. Finland is still in this, and you don't want them to strike, and the first way you do that is you get another one. You get up by three.
You want DeFore in front of the net, don't you, on
that
power play?
I do. I'm just thinking a 6-3. He's a big guy. He's got good hand eye. He has the ability to retrieve a puck. I'd like to get him a sniff at the very least.
Well, it's fascinating that they don't really get much going, at least on the last two power plays, in that crowded offensive zone. But when they do score a goal, it's end-to-end.
Well, it is end-to-end, and it's led by the back end in Sabrango and Zellweger with some very effective plays. Sabrango, we know what he can do, in particular in behind the net, playing physical. And when you have the ability to take a hit, you create opportunity. He just gets in there, and he takes the hit. And, of course, you get the retrieval. As you can see here along the wall, Zellweger is actually going to pick up this puck. Little cross check, little bump, picks it up, but he gets to the mid lane of the ice. This is critical. Now he's giving himself options. He skates right into the heart of the coverage and kicks it out. But because he continues on, he pulls the coverage back, opens up the lane for DeFore, who also changed the angle of his shot. Again, just the kick, the drive, and then the changing of the angle as he pulls that puck into his body for that goal, his third. And again, showing why DeFore has got good hands and a goal scorer.
I've been impressed with DeFore. He was in a spotlight position in the Memorial Cup, a go-to guy for his team. Not really in that position on this Team Canada, but he's a big guy. He can skate. He can contribute offensively. I like the way he plays.
James, I'm not in the habit of making predictions, as you know, but I am going to predict this. If Canada doesn't score on this next power play, or even if they do, maybe the next 3, 4, 5 calls are probably going to go against Canada in the third period, so buckle up.
But again, credit to Canada. You could have maybe called one on Zellweger on that little push to start the play. Bedard had a guy in a headlock at some point, but for the most part, they've been incredibly disciplined, which was one of the keys to this game. Zellweger, we've been focusing so much on McTavish. By the way, they added an assist for McTavish on that second goal, so he's now only 1 point away from the tying the Canadian record. But Zellweger continues to rack up the points as well. In fact, offensively, there's been no better defenseman in the tournament. He leads Emil Andrea, who was done winning the bronze medal for Sweden by 3 points. 11 points for Olin Zellweger. I'd expect he'll be on that tournament all-star team when it is done. So, what do we feel here going towards the third period? Does Finland have the momentum, even though Canada has that 1:14 on the power play, simply because of what they've done killing all those penalties?
Well, I think the 1:14 is going to dictate it. What does Canada do with that power play? Because if they come out of it with a big fat zero, guess what? Finland is going to create some momentum building, believing that they can get back in this game.
And if you don't get one on the power play, you don't want any more power plays the rest of the game. You just want to get back to 5-on-5, getting in and cycling, much like they did in the first period.
Now, Finland's got to be very happy where the game is at right now, because the Canadian power play could have ended this game. It hasn't, so they're still in it.
A 2-0 hockey game headed towards the third period. Dave Cameron behind the bench. I'm not going to get into details of what happened when he was there in 2011. The trophy is sitting right here. Somebody will hold it in 20 minutes or more from now. Canada and Finland. 20 minutes to gold here at the World Juniors. TSN. I mentioned McTavish getting that extra point that added assist on the second goal, so he's now up to 17. He's going to win the tournament scoring race. That is a given at this point, but 1 point away from tying that all-time Canadian record, still 2 goals away. And Zellweger, the defenseman, at 11 points. Remember, Thomas Chabot won the MVP in 2017 after he earned 10 points in the tournament. And look where Canada is dominating the plus-minus. This is a romp. McTavish and Zellweger both plus 14. Jack Thompson plus 12. Zellweger was plus 7 in one game against Slovakia. And Connor Bedard also on that list. Brock Faber, the lone non-Canadian there at plus 10. We'll take one more break and then the third period of play at the gold medal game from Edmonton. The Canadians up by 2. Logic again, tracking those quality shot locations, the slot shots for Canada. And look at that. When you have 9 minutes of power play time, you know you're going to rack it up. 19-3 in favor of Canada. The red dots representing the 2 Canadian goals where they were scored from. Here is your second period scoring summary. DeFore from Zellweger and that added assist for McTavish just 41 seconds in. But after that, Canada gets nothing. But they still have a minute and 14 seconds on this key power play to start the third period. To call it for you, Gord Miller and Mike Johnson.
You know, Mike, before the tournament began, there was a lot of questions about who would be made available. Pretty clear Mason McTavish is going to have a very good chance to make the Anaheim Ducks roster out of training camp. He wanted to come here and fought, in fact, to come here.
That's maybe the most impressive thing, is that he wanted it so bad. It would have been easy for him to say, no, you know what, I got to prepare for my NHL season. So he shows up, he's elected the captain, and he goes on and puts an absolute show on from start to finish in this tournament. Think about his evolution, though, Gord. He started out as the bona fide number one offensive centerman, put up a 6.4 goal game, and then he morphed into the checking centerman when Ridley Gregg went out with injury, all the while still piling up points, including this 2 in this game and the almost near breakaway goal. And it's gotten him within one of the all-time most points in a tournament record for Canada. It's a pretty exclusive company. That point tied him with Wayne Gretzky and Eric Lindros. And tell you what, he doesn't care about that board, but he cares about getting one more point in this power play. Because with 5 power plays in a row, you know at some point Canada's going to have to kill a penalty. And if they get one here, the third period becomes a lot more manageable than if they don't.
Finnish coach Antti Pettinen had a long conversation with the officials at the end of the second period. And McTavish wins the draw back for Zellweger. Olin Zellweger drops that back to McTavish. Feeds that for Bedard. Now Bedard crisscrossing the stank over. Bedard shoved down. McTavish comes in. Ties up Pudio. Bedard's back on it. Work that free for Stankoven. Logan Stankoven feeds it across. Johnson on the side boards for McTavish. Back he goes to Zellweger for Stankoven. Lots of traffic. Stankoven down to Bedard. The centering pass for Johnson misfired. McTavish back with it. McTavish has to go off a leg. Bedard with a quick chance and a save made by Juhai Jatkola.
Well, it's a different look. The one thing Canada is pretty efficient at is getting in the offensive zone. They rarely have trouble getting down there. And there you see Kent Johnson trying to find McTavish through the seam for his one timer where he scored a couple. And you never need to encourage Connor Bedard to shoot the puck. He is always looking to put it on net, put it in the net.
Off the face-off, Johnson back with it. Johnson slides that back to Zellweger. Cross he goes to Stankoven. McTavish Park in front, Stankoven, rink wide pass for Johnson. 20 seconds to go on the power play. Johnson walks in and shoots, Jekyll will save. McTavish had that bounced away from him, sent off the boards and into the Finnish bench. The face-off will stay in the Finnish zone with 12 seconds to go in the Canadian power play.
So it looks like maybe another penalty killed off for Finland. And Dave Cameron puts out his checking wingers with Gauthier as McTavish takes a seat on the bench. Canada's having a hard time getting the real quality look on the power play.
Seeley slaps it across to DeFore. DeFore shoots, that's what he saves, and he hangs on. We welcome both of you watching on TSN 3 who saw the Argos and Calgary play. Here, it's the gold medal game of the World Junior Hockey Championship. And we got more than 13,000 fans here this evening. Seeing the first ever meeting between Canada and Finland in a gold medal game at the World Junior Championship. And Tavish back on it. This is Canada's 19th gold medal game. It's the 28th overall played in the World Junior Championship. The very first World Junior back in 1977 actually had a gold medal game. Then they went to a straight round robin format until 1996. DeFore swings it across. Thompson with a shot from Fabiano Viakala. Four shots for Canada, that power play. And now Viro had that knocked away by DeFore. McTavish center for Wah. And the line held by Thompson. Spins and shoots. That went off Yoni Yermo and stung him. Viro plays it back down to the Canadian zone. Garan back to play it. Jack Thompson settles things down. Plays it back across the ceiling. High in the air to center ice. Chipped ahead by Othman. And he finds DeFore. DeFore bumped off the puck. Othman back on it. This is a heavy line for Canada. The Stapchuk with DeFore. And Othman, brought in now by Ratu. Ratu spins back, crisscrossing with Hirvonen. The top line for Finland back on the ice. Ostapchuk for Othman, held by Rafkin at the line for Niemela. And Topi Niemela winds his way in. Hirvonen was parked at the back door. Ratu shoots, and that's close by Hirvonen Garand. And he looks it right into the glove and hangs on.
Good job by Finland, killing another penalty. Put the puck down in the offensive zone, and you're right, tracking it right into the glove. This is a good look by Thompson. He's trying to go top blocker. That's an excellent release and a good save. And at this point for Yakula, he knows down two, he can give up another one to Canada next. That's almost it.
And again, Yakula played only once in the preliminary round, a 9-3 win over Slovakia. Lady Marilyn in the Ottawa draft pick, the place for Kingston in the OHL, was their starting netminder through the quarterfinals. But for the semifinal, the coach, Matthew Penman, played a hunch because Yakula has been very good against Sweden in exhibition games this year, in tournament games. He posted a shutout and gets the start in the gold medal game. Now, Sealy lost the puck at the side of the goal, put back in front. Here's Hamasomi, he lost it, and the puck back to center ice. Duran plays it down to Sealy. Drop back for Cormier. And Lucas Cormier banks it off the glass and back down to the finished blue line. Pass chipped in by Mata. Back to pick it up is Cormier. He was taken down by Jarvinti. And Forster lays it back down to the finish zone. Moving ahead is Yermo. Heels back to the Canadian zone. Drops it back to Mata. And once again, Garan with the glove save. Dylan Garan, native of Victoria. And there's his dad, Lauren. Happy birthday. When the schedule for the World Junior came out, the first thing that Lauren Garan said is, the gold medal game is on my birthday. He says Garan, by the way. Dylan says Garan, and the dad says, well, he's the big star of the family. We'll go with what he says.
How about a stress-free birthday for dad? Oh. And mom, I saw them on the way in, had a word. Dad seemed pretty calm and relaxed. Mom said she had a hard time sleeping last night, which is completely normal.
Off the draw, knocked down by Hirvonen. Hirvonen centers it for Ratu. Ratu. Pivots back in the corner. Feeds that back to Rafkin. Rafkin for Ratu. On the line, held by Niemela. He's got room, walks it in, shoots Garand, save. Rebound loose, but Hirvonen turned away and tight by Garand. And the rebound cleared back to center ice. We'll see the full push from Finland now here in the third period. Niemela lifts that down. Thompson back up to center. And Vero kind of accidentally on purpose turned the wrong way to draw an icing call.
That was a nice little inside pivot by Vero to draw the icing call. This is giving Canada problems all tournament long. The high rotation with the defense, when they get three guys in the offensive zone up by the blue line, Canada's hesitant on who to switch and when, and it allows the Emila to walk right into it. Now, good job for the two defensive down in front of the net to tie up, but still got to sort that out a little bit better.
Before, stick was taken out of his hands. Doesn't have one now. Hamasomi works it in, shoots, scores! Tipped in front. Hamasomi's got one. And the Finns are on the board, down by one. So the icing comes back to haunt Canada. A lost stick, and the puck winds up in the net. Alexa Hamasomi, Carolina's second round pick.
Right from the faceoff to four. Tries to get the puck out, but gets tangled up, loses his stick, and then a wrister on the way in. Oh, it's good body position by Carvin in. Gets over to Hamasomi, and then good luck seeing around Hellenius. It's like a lunar eclipse when he goes in front of the goaltender. And we talked about the need to score on all those power plays, because at some point, Finley would find a way to close it to one, and they have.
And now they have. Kotio back across to Yermo. Kemmel works in, shoots, Garand steers that away. NYA chops it into Hoffman. One-on-one with Kotio. Hoffman works in, the puck rolled off his stick, and Yermo has it back. Over 13,000 here tonight. Kemmel works his way in, holds and shoots. That's off a skate into the corner. Oh. Ostapchuk digging for it. Sobrango back on it. Pick free. Bailey sends it back in front for a great stop there. Hellenius point blank. And Denoyer was flattened in front of the Canadian goal.
Hellenius just laid into the back of Denoyer after the chance, after a great save by Garand, but no penalty signaled. And all up, there's the save, snatched it out of the air. Here comes Hellenius. Now here's the icing. Look at the pivot here by Vero. Oh, I don't think I can get that to the boards. Smart play, absolutely draws the icing, then the face-off, and then the wrister goal. Garand just lost that. It's an easy wrist shot to save if you see it, but if you can't see it, can't stop it.
Cormier lost the puck behind the net. Del Mastro and Cormier both trying to work it free. Forster goes racing to it. Hellenius steps into him, but it's poked ahead by Stankoven. That was the wall sealed by Rafi, who plays it back in deep. Carvinen works that free for Hellenius, who's stapled there by Del Mastro, one of the few people on the Canadian roster who could probably do that.
That's good down low coverage. They'll get a pin, separate the men.
Cormier hit for Johnson. Johnson drops it off. In comes Forster. Forster drops it across the stake over. The pass bounced away from him. Back down low is Forster. Rings it around to Del Mastro. And Del Mastro pivots back. At the line. Johnson, a hard shot. Rebound loses it over Forster. Oh, what a glove save by Jatkula. Juha Jatkula takes one away from Tyson Forster.
A little smile for Jatkula. That was pretty good. Yeah, it was. Point shot, Forster jumps on. He takes his time to try to string out Jatkula. And he's got one thing in the air only, his glove. Get it around the glove, you got a goal. Ah, snatches it out of the air. Well done by Jatkula. Forster will have nightmares about that one.
Bison waiting for it, moving in on Sobrango. Fires that back down to the Canadian zone as Rossi goes after it. Hervinen. Shoves Zellweger off the puck. Back of the line, Vero. Long shot goes off a stick, over the glass, and out.
What a huge save. I mean, Jatkula's been under pressure since it's become 2-0 to not give up a third. And Finland finally gets one. You can't give up one right after this. Someone, Forster doesn't handle it cleanly, but I don't know if he thought he just had more room, because there's room on top of the net if he gets it in the top half of the net for it to go in.
Glove down by Sobrango. Plays that back down to the finish zone as Dufour goes after it. Vero plays it away from him. Hamasomi. to score the first goal of the game for the Finns. They're now settling in a one-goal game here in the third period. Finland has a winning record all time in medal round games against Canada, 4-3. Bank ahead now for Gauthier. He lost it for a moment. Jarvinti kept it alive, but now Gauthier moves it out. And picked up by Yermo, DePutio. Bedard fell. And played back to the Canadian line, brought in by Mata. Mata swings it across. Jarvinti, a shot, put that high. Bounces by Yermo, and Bedard closes quickly on him. Rossi goes to DePutio. In comes Mata with it. Steps around Gauthier and shoots. Duran the save. Rebound looks at the side of the goal. Grant's pad is down. Simon Taito turned away. Furious pressure now from Finland. Hunting for a second goal. Cooley on it. And Will Cooley just flips that back down to the finish zone. This will be another icing call against Canada.
So this forward line is not sure their responsibilities in the neutral zone, because Bedard, Gauthier, Cooley, two times in a row, we're all kind of in position, and no one really covered anyone tightly. And you got to talk it out. Now, Bedard fell down. That's not just a time-wasting effort here to fix his skate blade as he gets a new edge put on. Oh, if he would have waited a little longer, they were going to let McTavish go on for him.
Gauthier will take the face-off against Oliver Kapanen. The cousin of Kasperi Kapanen, who scored the golden goal for Finland in the 2016 World Junior Championship in Helsinki.
Face-off win there for Gauthier.
But Canada gets the change started. Here is Niemelä with it. Tuppy Niemelä. Wins a pass, that skips right down to Duran. And he will glove that. 12:27 to go here in the third period. Alexa Hamasalmi gives the Finns new life, and then Juha Jakkola keeps it a one-goal game. The 2022 NFL season kickoff comes your way September 8th, a Thursday night showdown between the Bills and the Rams. Catch it at 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific on TSN and CTV, Canada's home for the NFL. These two teams have won 6 of the last 8 World Juniors, 3 gold each since 2014. This game features the top 6 point getters in the tournament. But they meet for the first time in the gold medal game. Kent Johnson for Canada is out there now, played the Finns in the gold medal game at the Men's Worlds back in May. There's a shot by Raskin, that's gloved by Granum, once again pushing and shoving, breaks out in front of the Canadian goal.
Alenius is just driving into the net. Anytime there's a whistle, anytime someone's around there, it just brings a bunch of traffic with them. And a good win on the draw against Stankoven, tough to do by Alenius. And Duran with a good glove save.
Late change attempted by Canada, but that's turned away. There is Kasper Pudio's billets from when he played in the Western Hockey League for Moose Jaw. Johnson plays that in. Niemelä drops that back. Topi Niemelä. Top D when this tournament was held here in 2021 in the bubble. Throws it back down to Helenius, works it free. Samuel Helenius spins across the top, drops that off for Viro. Viro shoots, hit a leg in front, picked up by Stankoven. He's away quickly with Johnson and Forster. Johnson works in on Viro. Throws it back in the corner. Niemelä tied up by Stankoven. Forster trying to dig the puck free and does. Swings it back across. Sullivan shoots. Ripped that just wide. Forster trying to dig that free. Honeys has got it back and banks it back to center ice before he makes a change. Swept back in by Meyenbach. Zellweger got it back up for Canada. He got stapled to the corner boards. And Sabrangle comes back to help out. That hit the referee. And McTavish has it back for Canada. Slides it ahead to Forster. He got tied up by Hirvonen. And Ratu picks it up. After Ratu spins back. Viro back across for Hamasalmi. Hamasalmi. Drives the finish goal. Lots of traffic in front. Hamasalmi works in. The shallow there by Wall. Drops it back. Ratu, a hard shot. Loose puck in front. Grant is down. Still loose it, but right through the crease by Hirvonen. McTavish chops at it. And Joshua Waugh trying to work it free. He does. Zellweger jumps in. Canada's changing as Zellweger works it with Waugh. Zellweger shoots. It goes off a stick and wide. From a sharp angle. Shot by Dufour. That was blocked by Hirvonen. Now picked back up. Waugh with a shot. That pinballed wide. Back at the point is Cormier. Cormier feeds that wide. The goal bounces back. Dufour trying to center. It goes off a skate. And lifted back up by Hirvonen to the Canadian zone. Dufour chips that down so there's no icing on the play. Now the pass is picked up by Ostapchuk. Plays it back down to Austin for Ostapchuk. Gets away from Pulio. Banks that back to Del Mastro. Plays it back down to the finish zone. 25-23, the shots on goal in favor of Canada, which had five consecutive power plays in the game. Ostapchuk. Plays it back in deep. Knocked down to center ice by Cormier. And Cormier lifts it back in. Yermo moves away from Gauthier, who stays on him, but is careful not to take a penalty. Move back down to the Canadian zone. Thompson goes back, takes a hard bump there from Lucas. Cooley trying to take it free. Move back at the point. Here's Rafkin with it. Crunch there by Cooley. Jack Thompson holds off Liukas. Centering pass goes back to Miemel. He's got time. He's it back across. He scores! Fed across to Joachim Kemmel and the game is tied.
What a feed from Niemela. Canada can't quite get it out. Great battle down low. Liukas keeps the puck alive. And then you see four defenders run below the goal line. And then puck heads out to Niemela. They all get chased over to Niemela. No one spots Kemmel. That's a brilliant seam pass and one-timer. No chance for Garand. Good finish for Kemmel.
Kemmel, the Nashville first-rounder, has scored in both games against Canada in this tournament. Had a really good year for JYP Yabusele as a 17-year-old, scored 15 goals in 39 games. So a 2-2 tie here in the third period. Amosomi digs it back out. Looks ahead. Carpenter drops it back. Amosomi shoots. That goes wide. Zellweger back on it. Around for Johnson, picked up by Stanko and puts it ahead for Forster. Here comes Carson Forster. Walks in, holds and shoots. That was blocked by Amosomi. Forster comes back in on it. Here's Stanko. As Canada changes D, Stanko swings it back in deep for Forster. Del Mastro comes on late. And Forster rings it back around. Vero. To Carbonen. Plays that back down to the Canadian zone and Garand out to play it. And Cormier back to Del Mastro. If they're tied at the regulation, it's 3-on-3 in overtime until there's a winner. There's no shootout. Hirvonen works in, long shot, blocked away by Garand. Picked up now by Väisänen for Puteo. Puteo shoots, skipped off the side of the goal. Rocky tries to center it, that's knocked away from Väisänen. Finns keep up the pressure here. Puteo. Fires that wide of the goal. Bounces right back in front. And Del Mastro back on it. On his backhand, tough play, but plays it off the glass and back to center ice. Rafkin snaps that pass ahead for Jarvinti. Finds Simon tie the work again. Garand freezes that. With Mata looking for the loose puck. Joachim Kemmel. First round pick of the Nashville Predators has Finland right back in it. It's a 2-2 tie in the third period of the gold medal game. Back here in Edmonton, this is the World Junior Championship Trophy. Some legendary names have held it. And Dave Cameron thought he had his hands on it in 2011. Canada had a 3-0 lead in the third period against Russia. The roof caved in. in one of the most epic collapses in the history of the gold medal game. Cameron's waited 11 years to coach this team again, and now a 2-0 lead has evaporated in the third period.
In the last 16 shots, Finland's had 13 of them. 13-3 run for Finland, as score effects, human nature, pressure, aggression. Canada trying to defend their way to the end of the game, which is not what Canada does well. They don't defend to their own end well. They're better off playing in the offense zone, attacking, being aggressive. Maybe a tie game helps them get back to that.
And a remarkable season for Finland in international hockey as Thompson was taken down to win the gold medal at the Olympics in Beijing. In the last, since 2010, 3 World Championship gold, 3 World Junior gold, 2 under 18 gold, and an Olympic gold medal. That's just on the men's side. And they have given Canada fits internationally over the years at every level. Back goes Thompson for it. Hacks it back around. Thompson. There's downtown Finland coming to Finland. Canada's going to go here. As the Finns touch up, Canada's getting a power play with 6:47 to go in the third period.
I mean, it's amazing the disparity in penalties, but you can't say this is not a penalty.
Kapanen gets a stick
in the hands of the defenseman.
Team Finland, player number 27, minor penalty, hooking.
And he's got it wedged in, can opener in the hip in the hands. I mean, it's a textbook hook. And so Canada, whose power play came into this game, 57%.
Eight for 14.
Of 14. And 0 for 5 in this one.
11 shots on the power play. McTavish, Bedard, Stankoven, Johnson the forward, Zellweger back at the point. McTavish wins the draw for Bedard, back to Zellweger, and Canada gets set up. Bedard for Stankoven. Logan Stankoven plays it back down to McTavish. Mason McTavish centers it, skipped away from Stankoven. Stankoven feeds it back to Zellweger. Cross it goes to Johnson. To Zellweger. Walks in. Johnson, a short angle shot. And Yakima got a piece of that. McTavish back on it. McTavish, great pass across. Johnson works in. Spins and shoots. That was blocked. As Abel Viro got in the way, it's sent back down to the Canadian zone. Garand leaves it there for Zellweger. Owen Zellweger drops it back for Connor Bedard. In comes Bedard across the line. Bedard spins back. McTavish tries to dig it free. The pass hit the official. And now it's poked away to change shorthanded. As busting in is Liukas. Comes in. The puck rolls off. Here's like a penalty coming now to Zellweger. And a slashing call will go to Zellweger. So that will end the power play, and the Finns will get one up the other side, their first of the game.
Canada number 3, 2 minutes slashing.
It's the same penalty they call on Mason McTavish's break.
And you could argue that Liukas was
in alone. That's one tap. Ooh. I mean, there's a tap in the hands. That's a slash. And maybe that caused Liukas to kind of mishandle the puck. Why he missed it was not a slash at the end there. And this is how close Canada was. Ken Johnson looking to go short side, and a beautiful block by Puutio. Oh, just a toe to skate on it. So 55 seconds, 4-on-4. And then Finland, which and their vaunted power play.
Yeah, scored in half the goal in the tournament on the man advantage. Funny is Finland came in with the worst penalty killing in the tournament.
If they win gold, if their penalty kills it, they're going to win it for them.
It allowed 6 power play goals on 12 attempts coming in. So here we go, 4-on-4. Brought in now by Mata. Mata comes in, gets around Cormier. Mata swings that back at the point for Biro. Across he goes to Niemela. And now Niemela with it. Niemela shoots. That goes just wide. Cormier races to it. And tied up there by Mata. And McTavish is almost off to the races. picked back up by Thompson. 10 seconds to go with the finish penalty, and then they'll be on the power play for just over a minute. Laid around to Will Cooley. And Cooley moves back in. Cooley in, shoots, back away by Akkola. Good hit in the corner.
They got a penalty on it. Wow. Hey, Ostapchuk's down in the corner, and he's still down.
Puccio, moments after that blocked shot, will go off, and the officials are now conferring. Now, if you're just watching for the first time, the officials quite often in this tournament called a five-minute major and then reviewed it on video. They can take it down to a two. There have been 7 5-minute majors and game misconducts called so far in the tournament. The crowd hollering five.
Ostapchuk gonna head down to the
dressing room. Ball on the ice is a major. The play is under further review.
So it's a 5-minute major on the ice. Now they'll review it.
Oh, yeah, he hasn't touched the puck yet, and it's an awful spot to push a guy 6 feet out. Very dangerous. I think Ostapchuk kind of feels him coming, but he gets caught off balance, and it's just an awkward, dangerous hit. Call on the ice is five. They can review, as you mentioned, take it back down to a two.
So the arm extension will be part of it by Puccio. When you extend the arms and put them in.
And internationally, they don't pay as much attention to the result and the stop trick that he's gotten up, and he is still sitting on the bench. Won't factor into this. It's just, what does that hook look like? And Antti Pettinen knows it does not look good.
The officials watching it, and Olin Zellweger is in the penalty box with them, looking over their shoulder.
He's doing the best to keep his thoughts to himself.
Referees are Sean Fernandez of the United States, Christopher Holm of Sweden. They'll be talking in conjunction with the video judge.
So at the very least, it's going to be five on or 4-on-4 for the duration of Zellweger's penalty. Could be a much longer power play after it expires. That is, it goes into Lockley though.
Right, here's the call from Fernandez.
After further review, the call on the ice is a 2-minute minor for boarding.
Yeah, I mean, it's a tough call. It wasn't right from behind. Canada desperately wants it to be five, but officials elected to take that one back down. So 4-on-4 again.
For 57 seconds. And then a brief Canadian power play if there are no more calls. Inside five to go here in the third period. Down to the wire we go. Raptor. And it's stripped away by Forster. And Forster back to Seeley. Bossy goes to Cormier. To Seeley that skipped away from him. And now he's got to hustle back with Ratu bearing in on him. Seeley brings it back around to Cormier. And Ratu's all over him. Again, Canada can't clear it out. Rafkin shoots at the flex wide. Forster knocks that down. And Forster spins away. Puts it back in for Cormier. He's got numbers with him. He's got Gauthier with him. In comes Cormier. Flips that wide to the goal. Forster back on it. Forster drops back for Gauthier. For McTavish off the bench. In comes Mason McTavish. And McTavish drops it back to Johnson. Seconds away from a Canadian power play. Johnson swings that back to Cormier. On comes Bedard. Connor Bedard off the bench. Feeds it back to Cormier for Zellweger. Back across for Cormier. To Zellweger. Crowd hollering for a shot. Zellweger. Back down to Johnson. 50 seconds to go on the power play. Johnson. As Cormier makes his way off the ice, Stankoven comes on. McTavish. Spins that back for Zellweger. In for Johnson. Walks right in. Feeds it back. Go McTavish on the outside of the post. And the crowd oohing and aahing with every scoring chance here in the period. Stankoven. Up ahead to Bedard. Bedard finds it out of McTavish. The puck at his feet. Picked off by Matta. And he'll send it down the ice. Zellweger. Back to pick it up. Being closely watched there by Weissman. And here is Bedard. Inside three to go in regulation. McTavish. Up ahead for Johnson.
He wanted these forwards to get off the ice for Canada as the penalty's expired.
Now Stankoven waits for it. One shot for Canada on that short power play. Logan Stankoven Works his way in. It bounces to Bedard. It's skipped away from him. Picked back up by Kapanen. Long bouncing puck knocked away by Garand. And the puck back to center ice. Here's Vero with it. Back for Haimasalmi. Kemmel works it and shoots, and Garand steers that away. Sabrango. Back around. Lifted out by Wah, who opened the scoring in this game for Canada. Haimasalmi, who got the Finns back in it. Now it goes off the skate of Wah and back down to the finish zone. Inside, two to go in the third. Vero drops it back to Haimasalmi. He steps around before. Haimasalmi. Long shot. That deflects wide. Seeley back for it. Ronan Seeley up for McTavish. And Mason McTavish, the captain, backhands it back down to the finish zone. Here's Dufour after it. He gets taken down in the corner by Rafkin. Johnson comes in to help out. Puck worked free to Kent Johnson. And now McTavish with a rolling puck. Back to Zellweger. In for Dufour. And Dufour plays that back down to Johnson. Shields off Rafkin, but spun around. And the ML lifts it back down to the Canadian zone over everyone's head. This will be icing, and there's tired Finns on the ice.
Hey, a minute 12 left. Only Canada wants to waste a timeout unless they want to keep McTavish on the ice. Make this tired group of Finnish defenders stay on the ice and get out there. Problem is, McTavish has been out there himself. Whoa. Dave Cameron loading it up. Bedard, Johnson, McTavish. These guys haven't played together much in this tournament.
1:12 to go in regulation. Faceoff won by the Finns. McTavish races to it. Rafkin up ahead for Hirvonen. Plays it back down to Niemela. And there's a minute to go in regulation. Overtime looming in Edmonton of the 2022 World Junior Hockey Championship gold medal game. Puteo at center ice, knocked down by Wah. And now Wah back on it. Joshua Wah brings it in. From a sharp angle, shoots, and Yakel will save on that. Here's Puteo back with it. 30 seconds to go in regulation. Puteo winds his way in. On Sabrango, shoots, and once again, Garand looks it right in the glove and hangs on.
Dave Cameron going for the win, though, loading up the offensive players, trying to find a way to score a goal late. Finland able to defend well enough to get their version of an offensive zone faceoff, from which they've already scored one in this game.
There will be a full intermission. It's a 20-minute overtime period. And as I said, they'll play until someone scores. Finland has won the gold medal at the World Junior Championship 5 times. Off the draw, there's Kimmel, dribbles back down. They've won on golden goals 3 times. Canada has won. Matt Halischuk back in 2008. As that shooting goes over the glass and out with 11 seconds left. The Finns won in 98, and a goal by Nicholas Hagman. 2014 by Rasmus Ristolainen. 2016, Kasperi Kapanen.
You think about the way this game has played out for Finland, being shorthanded as many times as they have, down 2-0 going to the third. They are delighted with where they're at.
Absolutely.
Heading into overtime. Think about that Jakola save on Forster when it was 2-1.
Off the draw, Vero plays it back in the final seconds. Niemela up for Kemmel. Kemmel plays that down softly on Garand, who steers that away as time expires at the end of regulation. And the gold medal game of the 2022 World Junior Hockey Championship is going to overtime. Canada led 2-0, but the Finns came back on goals by Haimasalmi and Kemmel to equalize in the third period. Amazing save by Jakola on Forster. One more goal will be scored in this tournament. It'll be a golden one.
Back in Edmonton, Alberta, just recapping what Gord said. 20-minute sudden-death overtime periods, 3-on-3. A goal must be scored. There will not be a shootout, and this is the first of the 15-minute intermissions. I don't think there'll be another one, 20 minutes, 3-on-3. And you can argue about the format. Most Canadian fans seem to love the NHL 5-on-5 as long as it goes. They can't do that at a World Junior Tournament. This was in response when Canada lost in the shootout in Montreal to the Americans. Everybody complained about the shootout. They've removed the shootout. You can argue whether 3-on-3 is a big improvement. I think it's better than the shootout. You'd prefer to see maybe 4-on-4 first and then 3-on-3. But what do you make of what we just saw?
I can't believe that not scoring on the power play. I said to kind of just regroup and get back to 5-on-5 hockey, but it zapped the life out of the Canadians, and the Finns have all the momentum right now, and Canada just has no energy. Somebody on this panel said this is so predictable what's going on out there at Tiger. I didn't predict this. I had no idea that could happen out there.
But don't you think it is predictable after all those failed attempts that you'd start to panic a little bit?
After 40 minutes, you could just feel the air out of the sails of Team Canada. Their legs looked heavy. The Finns were jumping and realized, the Finns have been shorthanded for 12 minutes and 8 seconds of this hockey game. And Canada has nothing really to show for it other than going to overtime. So, yeah. The Finns are playing with house money.
And we did talk about it after the second period, you know, that if they didn't make something happen with that minute and 14 that they had remaining on that power play, that they'd have to watch out because the momentum certainly could shift in Finland's favor, as it did, and we just saw. And they get those two goals. And it starts to know they have a lot of motion, and this is it. You could feel the juice. You could feel them coming. A lot of switches, and the first one's just innocent. You can see the net front present. Heimel Salmi just throws it to the net, and he gets his first. And then again, you know, working the motion, working the cycle. This is what we talked about in the opening, that they love to play down below and along the wall. Beautiful play there by Topi Niemelä. Just recognize that everyone was laser focused on him and makes that thread the needle pass to Niemelä, who's been there arguably Finland's best player, and gets his fourth of the tournament.
The World Juniors has a long tradition of a goalie we've never heard of standing on his head. Usually it's some Latvian goalie or a German goaltender. This is an amazing story. Juha Jakkola, who was not the starter at all for Finland going in. People were surprised when he started the semis.
Yeah.
Stood on his head there. He's done it again here.
Yeah, absolutely. The quarterfinals, the semis, Juha Jakkola was not the goaltender of record in terms of being the number one goaltender for Finland. Levi Marilainen was that guy, but the coach lost confidence, decided to play a hunch and put Jakkola in, and what a tremendous decision that turned out to be. Unbelievable glove save there on Forster over and over again. In the third period, when the game is very much on the line, he reaches over and makes a couple of absolutely fantastic saves. Jakkola has developed into one of the big stories in this game because the goaltending for Team Finland has been outstanding.
He looked solid in the last part of that period. I was watching him. There were some cross-crease plays there, and he was getting across, and I said, oh, boy, this guy looks dialed in. So to beat him here 3-on-3 in overtime, James, they're going to have to make a good shot because he looks really dialed in right now.
It's 3-on-3 instead of 4-on-3, or maybe the game would have been over if that was called a major on Kasper Pudio. Let's show the penalty one more time, and you got the referees had a long chance to look at it. What do you think?
It's very simple to me. This is not a major because he got up so quickly, and a credit to him for getting up so quickly, because I think if he lied on the ice for possibly a minute or two, that is called a 5-minute major. A lot of times the referee's reaction to a play like that, if he looks really hurt and stays on the ice, it's called a major. He got up quickly, and credit to him. I'm not quite sure what I have done, what I would have done in that situation, but he got up quick, and I'm sure that factored into the ref's decision.
I think the 2-minute was the correct call, yeah. But in this tournament, they almost automatically call 5-minute majors for anything that goes into the boards. That is one of the very few majors that has been overturned when they went to video review. And so it surprised me a little bit, because as soon as they huddled, said 5 minutes, they go and look at the video. I've only seen that one other time in this tournament where they went with the minor instead of the major.
Yeah, we've been seeing them all tournament long, a ton of 5-minute majors.
I said off the top, this was not the rivalry that the traditional Canada-USA, Canada-Russia rivalry, but if you think of what Finland's done to Canada over the last decade, remember that Mitch Marner team that was a good team that ran up against in Helsinki against Finland and lost in the quarterfinals? And then 2018, which was a fantastic World Juniors. The crowds in Vancouver were unbelievable. Canada was looking great.
They stunned them in that game.
They run into Finland in the quarterfinals, and this one goes to overtime. That was 4-on-4 overtime at that point, and there it was. Finland winning and going on to win a gold medal.
Didn't Noah Dobson break a stick on the way down the ice, and then they came back?
Yeah, it was one of those moments.
I went to the airport right after the game, Jimmy.
That was also the year you lost your gold medal. That was a tragic World Juniors all in all for
Let's move on to something positive. Canada goal in overtime.
Well, we'll get your predictions for who may score in overtime when we return. We'll also look back at the bronze medal game, which seems like about 3 days ago now. Sweden and Czechia, both with a lot of painful memories at this tournament. One of them, the guys in blue. and yellow eliminated those memories. Way, way, way earlier today, it feels like Sweden and Czechia in the bronze medal game. They haven't fared well in bronze medal games, 3-12 overall. You figured the Czechs, this was a bigger game for them than the Swedes, but maybe not. Fabian Lisell showing all sorts of speed, wraparound goal. And the Swedes have a 1-0 lead. Didn't see nearly enough from the Swedes like that in the tournament. The offense has kind of sputtered the entire way, but not here. After it was 1-1, that's Isaac Rosen giving Sweden the lead, and he's got a beautiful World Junior souvenir. Third period, Rosen was the Sabres pick, so is this guy. Linus Jodin streaking in, and that would pretty much seal it. The Swedes have their third medal in 5 years. The gold still eludes them. They haven't won one in a decade, but they win the bronze here. Czech Republic, still a step up. They finished seventh at this tournament so many times in the last decade, including the last 3 years. All right, here we go. We don't often get to do this at the World Juniors. Pick a winner from each team. We'll let Cheryl go first.
I'm going to go with the captain who came back to get a gold medal for this country with Mason McTavish. And I'm going to go on the defensive side for Team Finland with Kasper Pudio.
All right.
I'm going to go with Kent Johnson for Canada and Atu Ratu for a bunch of different reasons for Finland.
O-Dog, by the way, loves cats, and he proclaimed today that if he gets another cat, its name will be...
Katu Ratu.
Bob McKenzie.
I'll go Connor Bedard for Canada and Joachim Kemmel for Finland.
All right, and that will leave me. Okay, I'm going to go Stankoven for Canada and Roope Järventie, the Ottawa Senators prospect for Finland, who's been lethal mostly on the power play so far. So there you go. Once again, 3-on-3 until it's over. They'll play a full 20 minutes if they have to. I'd be shocked if it goes a full 20 minutes. Dylan Garand and Team Canada set to come out of the tunnel for 3-on-3 overtime to decide gold at the World Juniors. Once again, we thank Sport Logic for tracking the slot chances. 23 for Canada, 7 for the Finns, but the only thing that really matters, those red dots, 2 of them for Finland in the third period to send this one to overtime. Your scoring summary, all blue and white flags in that third period. Emil Salmi at 4:09, Joachim Kemmel at 10:46. We don't know who will get the golden goal. We know who will call it. Gord Miller and Mike Johnson with overtime from Edmonton.
And the Canadian players have to look at what's in front of them, but it's hard not to think about what just happened.
Yeah, to think about how close Canada would have been and how many opportunities they had to not be heading to this overtime. You think about the 7 power plays, of course, and they were not able to score one goal on just 12 shots. Think about Tyson Forster, an incredible chance, wide open net that Jakola makes an incredible save on. These are the moments that kind of stick with you as what if chances, blocked shots, great saves, missed passes, whatever it might be. It was really just going to take just one more play for Canada, and they would have got this game finished off in regulation. They were not able to. Credit Jakola, credit to the Finnish defense. And now we go to 3-on-3 to get that.
This is the 28th gold medal game in the history of this tournament, the 10th to go to overtime. 2 ended in shootouts. The other 7... golden goals. Canada has won. That was Matt Halaschuk in 2008. The Finns have 3. And they just beat Canada with a golden goal at the Men's Worlds, coming back to Kerry Mannin scored in extra time. 3-on-3 in overtime. Antone's the winner. And away we go. McTavish and Johnson for Canada. Zellweger on defense. It's Ratu with Hirvonen up front and Niemela on the back end for Finland. Niemela. Lead pass for Hirvonen. Poked away by Zellweger. He was intended not to last a long time since they went to 3-on-3. Zellweger. Tied up by Hirvonen. Finds Johnson. And Kent Johnson moves out. Being harassed there by Hirvonen. 3 Finns closed in on him. And Johnson knocks it back down to the finish zone as Zellweger moves off and McTavish as well. You've talked about it so many times, Mike, in the NHL, that line changes are such a big factor here. In comes Mata on Forster. Mata works in. They watch there by Forster, swings back to center ice.
On some level, defensive zone coverage for Canada should be easier because it's 3-on-3, it's man-on-man. No way you can get confused.
Stankoven back out there for Canada. Yarvinson works in. He's poked check there by Ceiling. Chance the other way. Forster has it across for Stankoven. Stankoven with Forster in, shoots, and Yakula makes the stop.
One of the very best ways to create offense 3-on-3 is the bend but don't break. You give a rush, you play good defense, and then you counter quickly, and that's how you try to create your odd man rush. Good defense by Ken on the rush. Now you get Stankoven with a bad gap, getting to the middle on his strong side, and he puts one in on Yakula.
And now the two good friends, McTavish and Bedard, are up there for Canada. Chemistry from the get-go for them, back with the under-8 teams in 2021. McTavish wins the face-off back, but Zabrango has to retreat to center ice. Being shouted there by Vaisanen. Zabrango up for Bedard. In he comes, one-on-one with Rafkin. Shoots, that was blocked by Rafkin. Bedard knocks it down to McTavish. He's loose in the corner. McTavish swings back, drops it off to Bedard. That's poked away to chance now for Rafkin, the defenseman. He's jumping in. Back comes Zabrango. Rafkin spins back. He's got help arriving as Hellenius jumped on for the Finns. Back at the point. That long shot taken there by Lucas. Duran drops it down for Zabrango. Lead pass to Bedard. One-on-one in the envelope. In comes Connor Bedard. Walking in, shoots, and Yakula gets a piece of that. McTavish almost knocked that free. Now it's a 3-on-1 for Finland. In comes Liukas, drops it back to the envelope. Liukas shoots into there and makes the glove save. Drops it down. McTavish taken down by Hellenius. Hellenius centers it. Liukas in, plays it across. It's out of the wall. It's saved by McTavish.
He pulled it out of the air. He pulled it out of the air.
Incredible. McTavish in across the line. If it was in, they'll review it and sound the horn, but it doesn't appear to have gone in. In comes Kent Johnson. Johnson shoots him a sharp angle. Yakko the save. On comes Stankoven calling for it. Zellweger's up deep. Zellweger tries to knock that free. Now he retreats as Hellenius picks it up. The crowd still buzzing about that near goal, the 3-on-1 rush for Finland. In comes Ratu. Walks in, holds. Ratu spins back. He's got Puntio and Hermia with him. Puntio. Back across to Ratu. Ratu feeds it across. Hermia trying to center. That bounced away. Race for it now. Ceiling trying to get to it. And Ratu had to retreat as Ceiling got a stick on him. Almost a breakaway for Johnson. Now Stankoven. 2-on-1 to Johnson. In comes Stankoven. Pulls it back away. Can't find it. Johnson in the line. Oh, the safety mouse scores. Kent Johnson at the only goal in Canada. Worth the wait. With an incredible save. The officials are going to look at this
to see that the McTavish defensive play didn't get across line. This is incredible. Chip Butler was going right in. That's out of the air. Oh, onto the line. And it was McTavish who made the bad decision to give up the 3-on-1. And he bails himself out. He knocks it out of the air, straight down and off the goal line. No question that puck did not get across the line. What a great look at it here. It could not be closer. It could not be closer. The two best offensive players, Bedard and McTavish, scraping it, desperately keeping it off the line. Oh, it could have bounced anyway. Here's the final call. I'm going to go talk to...
Christopher Holmes going to talk to the Finnish coach, Antti Pennanen. and explained him that the puck was not in the net. So the celebration is on. Canada has won gold again at the World Junior in incredible fashion.
That's one of the craziest 3 minutes of overtime I've ever seen. Chances galore, back and forth they go. And then Stankoven with a brilliant pull, keeps it alive and gets it over to Johnson, who thinks he's missed a wide open net. But then he stays with it. The ability to not panic in a tight situation, Ken Johnson marveled at his composure, at his hands, at his vision. And man, oh man, the guy who has more shots, more chances, more expected goals the whole tournament of anyone ends the tournament with a little rebound.
What
flip.
A save.
I mean,
Yakla,
save to start it, but Johnson, he doesn't panic. A lot of guys lose their cool when they don't make the first one, but he scrapes it out of there. And
by the way, you heard La Bamba play a moment ago. It was the favorite song of the late Joey Moss, who worked here for the Oilers for a long time, and of Ben Stelter, who passed away, young six-year-old boy. His funeral procession was yesterday, went right by this building. He was a huge Oiler fan, loved hockey. And now Edmonton is celebrating a gold medal win. Kent Johnson, the fourth player in history to score in the World Junior, the World Championship, and the Olympics. And look at Mason McTavish with Kent Johnson.
That is special.
All right, here's Tessa Bonhomme with the gold medal winning goaltender, Dylan Garand.
Dylan, first of all, congratulations. We got to walk through that overtime. That was a wild one. That was a wild one. That goal that Mason saved. Walk me through that. What'd you see? What'd you feel?
I pushed out, and then he kind of passed it. It went up and over me. And I look back, and Mac just pulls it off the line. Oh, my God. What a feeling. Then we go down and score. No better feeling right now.
I can imagine how your father's feeling. It's his birthday. You going to get him the game puck as a present, or is this enough?
Yeah, I can't even hear the crowd so loud. They're so awesome tonight. Oh, what a win.
I got to ask you about Devin Levi, your old teammate. You guys won silver back in 2021 together. You promised him you were going to come back out here and get him the gold medal. What's your message to him now?
Oh, I know he's watching. He's meant so much to me. Oh, just a great feeling. I'm so happy.
Congratulations. Go enjoy with your boys.
Thank you.
So we're going to have the silver and gold medal presentations, the Canadian anthem. This tournament was scheduled for Christmas time. The pandemic got in the way, rescheduled for August. And Canada and Finland, this rivalry has taken on epic proportions at the Women's World Championship level, the Men's World Championship, the Olympics, you name it. Here's Tessa Bonhomme with the captain of Team Canada and a pretty good goaltender, Mason McTavish.
Mason, we got to start with the goal you saved in overtime. What was going through your mind? What'd you see? How the heck did you pull that off?
Yeah, I don't know, to be honest. I mean, I just saw it trickling over, and I thought, oh crap, I gotta do something here. And I don't know what happened. Honestly, just got lucky.
You bartered with the Ducks organization to be able to come back, play, and get the job done. Well worth it, I assume.
Oh, yeah. I mean, this is the best feeling ever. You can never get enough of this. I remember I won gold at U18s, and the same feeling as this. It's the reason you play hockey for games like these and opportunities like these. So, to come out top there. It's a great Finland team. They played so hard. They had so much pride and so much courage to come back. And for us to come out like we did with Ken Johnson's goal, it's unbelievable. I'm so proud of this group.
Pretty resilient group. You lose Ridley Gregg, the lines get shuffled. You're given a new role. What is that? What made this group so special?
Yeah, I mean, you go up and down this lineup. Anybody can play anywhere, and I think that's what made us so special. And it's an unreal feeling right now.
Looks like the black jerseys were the right choice. Congratulations.
Thank you.
So time now for the player of the game presentations.
Jeff World Junior Championship.
And I got to think Mason McTavish will figure large in that. What a battle.
That was incredible.
The best player of Team Finland, et le numéro 21, number 21, Aleksi Heimosalmi.
Scored the goal that got them back in it. the top D at the under 18 tournament in 2021. And a great future for the Finns. They could bring 10 back to Halifax and Moncton.
The best player of Team Canada, et le numéro 23, number 23, Mason McTavish.
He's going to be busy for the next few minutes.
I just want to hang out there for a while.
He's got a trophy to accept. There's also the awards to be handed out at some point. Now the officials will be honored.
Now to present the officials from today's game with trophies recognizing their involvement in today's game is Henrik Bach-Nielsen, IIHF Vice President and Tournament Chairman. We kindly ask the officials to please step forward to receive their trophies.
And Henrik Bach-Nielsen is the head of the organizing committee for the Women's Worlds coming up next week in Denmark. He's a native of that country and a longtime proponent of women's hockey.
And good on these referees, because there were a disparity in penalties called, but sometimes the game dictates that be the case. You don't have to manage the game so the penalties are the same. You call the way they saw it, and they did that all game long.
Finland won bronze here in 2021, so they've gone gold in 2019 in Vancouver. Bronze in 2021 in Edmonton, and now silver in 2022.
Heikki Hietanen, IIHF Council Member, to present the silver medals to Team Finland.
Heikki Hietanen is the IIHF Council Member from Finland, and he'll hand out the silvers. It's been a remarkable year, as we talked about.
Number
gold
one,
in World Championship, gold at the Olympics.
Number two, le numéro deux, Matthias Rajaniemi. Number three, le numéro trois, Ruben Rafkin.
You knew coming into this game,
four,
no matter how it played out,
quatre, Yoni Yermo.
Finland was going to make it tough.
Six, yeah.
Tough the until
six,
they win, or tough
Emil
until
Giro.
Canada
number seven,
finds a way to beat them.
Set,
and
Niemela.
Certainly they did not back down for
number
second.
10,
down 2-0, pushed,
Kasper
evened
Puglio.
It up.
Number 13, le numéro 13,
fractions
Robbie Jarventier.
Of an inch from winning
number
a gold
15,
medal.
Le numéro 10,
could
the
not be closer.
Number 18, le numéro
that
18,
is a play that will be talked about for a long, long
number
19,
time. Le numéro 19, Yusu Mayenpa, number 20.
Back in 1994, in a game against Sweden, Rick Girard, a Vancouver Canucks pick, pulled the puck off the goal line to save a game and a gold medal for Canada.
Think about it, though. The guy who was 1 point away from tying the all-time Canadian points record for offense. He's going to be remembered for this tournament for a defensive play.
Well, he does have good hands.
No joke. That's what he needed out of the air. And he found it. He says he didn't know what happened. He got lucky. I think it's probably a lot more skill than luck.
Number 29
for Mason McTavish.
Kasper Simon Taival. Number 30, le numéro 30, Yanni Lampinen. Number 31, le numéro 31, Juha.
Can't say that the hunch on Juha Jakola was wrong again. He was full value to get his team to overtime.
Number 34, le numéro 34, Atu Ratu. Number 35, le numéro 35, Ronnie Karvonen. And number 37, et le numéro 37, Joachim Kamel. Team head
so
coach.
The Finns receive their silvers.
Team assistant coaches.
Country of 5.5 million people.
And Yanni Sinkonen.
The Finnish word is sisu. It means
manager,
collective
Nico
strength or
Kuzma.
Guts.
They play with a lot of it.
And they show it time after time, tournament after tournament.
It's not a coincidence anymore. Different ages, different genders, different teams, different eras, and they all bring that energy every time. That was a great game.
It really was. Game. I mean, there were so many twists and turns to it.
Some of these guys will be at camps together in a couple weeks.
Yeah, a lot of prospective NHL teammates together. And Antti Pennanen, you can see the disappointment. Kimmo Karanen is the head of their national team programs, and they've been pretty productive this year. This is sweet vindication for Dave Cameron. Waited 11 years for this moment.
And what would he have been thinking as the previous time they were up 3-0, lost in the third period. This time they're up 2-0.
You watch Canada outscored 7-0 in the third period of two gold medal games, and they come out with a gold. And now the presentation of the second place trophy to the Finns. There's a lot of closeness between Finland and Canada. 30 years ago, the Finns took a lot of
to present the IIHF trophy to the
teaching and
medalist.
Learning from Canada, brought it back home. They've adapted it to their own style, but the Finnish League Championship, this SM League Championship, is called the Canada Cup.
Please come forward to accept the award.
And there is Ronnie Hirvonen, the Finnish captain.
Had a good tournament. Tremendous passer of the puck. Mm-hmm. Picks up the one they didn't want.
And now it's time for the presentation
joining
of the gold
Henrik
medals.
Bach-Nielsen, please welcome to the ice Andrea Skinner, Interim Chair of Hockey Canada Board of Directors, to present the gold medals to Team Canada.
It has been a tough few months for Hockey Canada, no question about it.
Number one, le numéro un, Sebastian
Kosa. And time now
Kosa.
For the gold medals. Sebastian Kosa from Fort McMurray, Alberta.
Number three, le numéro trois, Olin Zellweger.
Olin Zellweger from Fort Saskatchewan, Alberta. Carson Lambos from Winnipeg, Manitoba. Lucas Cormier from Sault Ste. Marie de Kent, New Brunswick. Donovan Sobrango from Kingston, Ontario. Number eight, Ronan Seely from Olds, Alberta. Number nine, Joshua Waugh from Saint-Georges, Quebec. Logan Stankoven from Kamloops, BC. Riley Kidney from Enfield, Nova Scotia. Tyson Forster from Alliston, Ontario. Kent Johnson from Port Moody, BC. Brennan Hoffman from Pickering, Ontario. Connor Bedard from North Vancouver, BC. Ridley Gregg in uniform to accept his gold medal after being injured in the quarters from Lethbridge, Alberta. Elliot Denoyer from St. Hyacinthe, Quebec. Zach Ostapchuk from St. Albert, Alberta. Nathan Gaucher from Richelieu, Quebec. Jack Thompson from Corliss, Ontario. Mason McTavish from Carp, Ontario. Ethan Del Mastro from Fieldton, Ontario. William DeFore from Quebec City. Will Cooley from Toronto. Ryan O'Rourke from Bowmanville, Ontario. Brett Brochu from Bell River, Ontario. And the goalie, Dylan Garan, the starter, and a gold medalist, Dylan Garan from Victoria, BC. Head coach Dave Cameron from Kinkora, PEI. Assistant coaches Michael Dick from Lethbridge, Louis Robitaille from Montreal, Dennis Williams from Stratford, Ontario, the goaltending consultant Olivier Michaud from Belay, Quebec, the video coach Brian Saint-Louis from Hull, Quebec, and the Canadian staff who receive their medals.
And it was great to see Damon Hunt on the ice in uniform. He was injured the day before the tournament started and was unable to play. But Ethan Del Mastro got the late call. Great to see him still part of the group, part of the team.
Now a little change the protocol.
Now please rise for the National Anthem of Canada. Maintenant, merci de vous lever afin d'écouter l'hymne national du Canada.
Thank you. there's one more piece of business. The presentation of the trophy by IHF President Luc Tardif.
Now please welcome Luc Tardif, IIHF President, to officially close the 2022 IIHF World Junior Championship.
First of all, I think we can congratulate the two teams because we had a fantastic game to watch. Beginning of January, when we had to stop the tournament because of the COVID, we left Edmonton a little bit sad, but we made a promise that we will organize for those kids the edition World Junior 2022, and we made it. Thank you, Edmonton. Thanks to the fans, the volunteer, the organization committee, Hockey Canada, for the works done. Fantastic. And I think everybody enjoyed this tournament. Now, I will close first officially the tournament. On behalf of the International Ice Hockey Federation, I declare this World Junior 2022 closed. But now that's time to celebrate. Captain, please.
Official song for Canada since
bring
Buffalo.
Bring it back forever.
It's all the fans want, and it plays here as the Canadians one by one hand off the World Junior Championship trophy. James Duffy back alongside Cheryl Pounder, Jeff O'Neill, and Bob McKenzie will stay with you while the Canadians stay on the ice. I think of the moments we've witnessed at this tournament, the John Slaney goal, the Everly goal in Ottawa in the semis, the Jonathan Toews shootout in 2007, Matt Halaschuk with a golden goal for Canada, Akil Thomas back in 2020 finishing off that Canadian comeback. I don't know, maybe the Everly goal, but that was one of the craziest sequence of events I've ever seen.
And it was the trifecta, the three parts to it. I thought that the horn was going to blow because I thought the puck went in the net at the other end. And miraculously, Mason McTavish kind of tapped it out of the air. It bounced around the goal line, and then it went the other way. Unbelievable toe drag by Stankoven, and Johnson puts in the winner. What a hockey game.
And so unbelievable that Mason McTavish, who came back, wanted that gold medal so badly, to just make that incredible play on the goal line to tap it down and have it go the other way. You could just see the emotion of all these guys. Every national team minute is a privilege, and you can see it on all of their faces.
Well, to your point, James, we've covered 35-plus World Junior Championships, and you're right, the Everly goal was insane on one level, but to see a puck going into the net and Mason McTavish knock it down, it not bounce into the net, have his stick go for it, have another Canadian player's stick go for it, and not knock it into the net, and hit the post with it, and then pull it out, and then have them come back down the other way, and make a play that Yatkula made an amazing save on Johnson's first shot. And I thought they were, the Finns were off to the races the other way, and Johnson was able to follow up on it. It was really an improbable ending.
Well, and it's just the emotion of the game, right, guys? I mean, you saw the Finns just lying on the ice in defeat. Everyone left absolutely everything out there on the ice. This is a long tournament, you know?
The Finns deserve a lot of credit, Cheryl. I mean, it was 2-0, and people say you got to just hang in there and get through the penalty kills, blah, 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 the center stuff. But they knew that Canada was the better team there outmatched, but they stuck with it. And they had all the momentum going into that overtime, and it looked like they were going to be the team to win this gold medal, and some unbelievable, I guess, fortune for the Canadians and breaks, and an unbelievable play at the other end to end the hockey game.
12 minutes and 8 seconds were the power play time for Canada, to your point about the Finns. And then in the third period, the Finns outshot Canada 17-10 in the third period.
Remember how we talked endlessly about the best power play in the tournament always wins gold, and that was going to be the deciding factor in this game. So much for that, Bob.
And the worst penalty killers, the Finns, and they were perfect on this day. And
that's what makes hockey beautiful, is when it makes no sense whatsoever. Just one finishing thought on that McTavish thing. Considering the context of overtime in the gold medal game, I think it's the best non-goalie save I've ever seen, and maybe in hockey history.
Well, I'll say this. Cheryl picked Kent Johnson to score the game-winning goal. But what I'm saying is, you must share it. You must share it, because
there's not a chance in the world
that Kent Johnson is able to score that goal if it's not for McTavish. So, two winners on the goal.
We were talking about McTavish, James.
That's Ridley Gregg. I just wanted to say a word about him again. Maybe with McTavish, Canada's best player until he got hurt. Was going to join us on set today, but was still so upset about the injury and having to miss this game, and to see him out on the ice in uniform, lifting that trophy.
Going back to McTavish, his coach calling him, and we were discussing the 200-foot game and what it really means, and he's looked like an NHL player and a leader and a guy that does it all for his team. That's an unbelievable play to save the gold medal right on the goal line. Most guys are like, I don't want to touch that puck and I don't want to go near it. And the calmness to get that play done, it's unbelievable.
And that goal makes head coach Dave Cameron's life much more enjoyable. Because if Canada loses in overtime, everybody's going to trot out what happened in 2011 in Buffalo when some guys named Panarin and Tarasenko and
scored five unanswered goals. And he's had to hear about that. Dave Cameron's a good hockey coach, and he's had to hear about that ever since.
Absolutely.
It's the one. It's the thing that
and
people most associate with.
And it would have been the same
him.
Script here. 2-0 lead, lose in overtime. People would have said you blew another lead. And instead, they get the goal. And, I mean, what it comes back to is hockey's a game of luck. And let's be honest. The McTavish play was incredible skill to do it, but there was a large dollop of luck involved.
I'll tell you what, I would know where that would have gone if I tried it. It's a ton of skill as well. You know, almost looked like a lacrosse player move there.
Here's the photo that will hang on their walls for probably the rest of their lives. Oh, you have one from 95. Cheryl has 8 of them, 6 world championships and 2 Olympics.
Unbelievable moment. I think that's what connects you for a lifetime are these moments. And I know you know that.
It's the most important picture right there. And it's always a battle to get close to the trophy, because that's the most important part of the picture. You see everybody trying to cram in there close to the trophy.
Well, the right guy has it.
But that's the picture everybody's going to have in their basement.
The right guy has it. Mason McTavish, who you guys mentioned, did not have to come back for this tournament. A lot of players from different countries chose not to come with NHL camps coming in. And that's not a knock on them. That's completely understandable. But for him to want to come back after the year he had playing for 7 different teams and to be the best player in the tournament and then to make that play.
And then going late into the Memorial Cup as well and not ending the way he wanted it there and then finding a way to come back and do it. And as you know, these training camps, these months are long and they're exhausting and you have to pay your dues. You have to give the sacrifices, and these guys did that and they've been rewarded. And as mentioned, they'll be connected to forever by this gold medal.
And who knew? All tournament we were counting counting Mason McTavish down to, is he going to get the record for most points, most goals in a tournament? Instead, all we're talking about is the defensive play he made.
I'll never talk about the goals. It's all I'll talk about is that one play.
And it's everyone, really. I mean, Ostapchuk, you know, the little plays and the detailed plays that make such a difference in a game. And every single player contributed on this team, and that's how you get that trophy.
As the officials continue to pass the trophy around, we remind you that this breaks the tie of the last decade. It's been an amazing decade at the World Juniors, with three nations dominating and trading gold medals. Every 3 years, the U.S., Finland, and Canada have won a gold medal. So this was the tie, 3-3-3, and the Canadians break it and win their fourth to win the decade in 2022. And what a difference to have this crowd for this gold medal game. This was tough, folks, this tournament. The non-Canadian games, if you watch them, there was nobody here. I could count the crowds in some of the early games. The Canadian crowds were decent and built as the tournament went along, as we expected they would. There'd be 1,000 or 1,500 more every single game. This was the first game where that lower bowl at least was packed and it felt like a gold medal
game.
And
you feel it as an athlete. You know when the crowd is behind you and you get energized, and there was certainly a ton of energy in this building today. And as I look forward to Halifax as well, one of the greatest barns I ever played in, with the energy beneath, just feeling the roar of everyone in the building, and it pushes you forward, in particular in overtime.
And we thought Kent Johnson's Michigan would be the highlight. They played forever for him, and I think he's one upped himself with that golden goal on a second try. Connor Bedard, by the way, will be back. We don't know who exactly will be back at Christmas time in Moncton and Halifax. We know Connor Bedard will be back after another good tournament for him. With four more goals, he's got 8 World Junior goals, and he may have a chance to set the all-time Canadian record before he is done. What do we leave with as far as your thoughts on this? This was your first World Juniors to cover for TSN. You've covered a lot of World Championships, but oh no, we're thrilled to have you.
But no, you know, incredible. In particular today, you know, you learn so many lessons over the course of a tournament, the way a team plays, and you see different players and how they come alive, whether it's Wrigley Gregg going down, Stankoven stepping up, being the heartbeat of his team. And this is why you do it. You do it for these moments that uplift us and create hope and optimism. And certainly it was just electrified, and I know it really resonated with me throughout this whole tournament.
I think the best team won the tournament, James. Canada was a steady build. It wasn't a game of perfect for them, but they were a dominant team, and their best player, who was dominant in the tournament, made kind of the game-breaking play for them, and it wasn't a goal. It was a defensive stand right at the goal line, and then it went the other way, and Johnson scores the goal.
And how about Canada winning a gold medal without having to play three of the world powers? Of course, Russia not here. They don't end up facing the U.S., and they don't play Sweden, only the Finns twice.
For much of the tournament, it felt like a summer hockey tournament for the longest time because of the lack of crowds, because of the pall that was cast over because of the scandal involving Hockey Canada. It didn't feel anything like a World Junior Championship that you would normally have at Christmas time. But in this particular moment, with the stands mostly full and the fans obviously enjoying it, and such a miraculous moment that will stand in the annals of World Junior history, the McTavish save, not allowing that puck to go in the net and then come back down the other way, it ended up pretty spectacularly given the circumstances.
And so we look ahead to Halifax and Moncton at Christmas time. Let's show you one more time the groups, which unusual for the World Juniors because of the short turnaround. They set these groups based on the world rankings and the performance at this tournament over the last few years. So Canada, the gold medal winner, will be in with Sweden, Czechia, Germany, and Austria. Remember, the Russians continue to be banned. Finland, U.S., Latvia, Switzerland, and Slovakia will be playing in Moncton. The gold medal game, of course, in Halifax. Echoing what Bob was saying, this was a tough tournament to cover, being in the middle of summer with small crowds and the backdrop of the Hockey Canada scandal, which we will continue to cover on TSN and continue to have the conversations towards change. But for the 250 players from these 10 countries, we're glad it happened, because it wasn't fair that it was canceled in December. These kids grow up wanting to play in this tournament, dreaming of playing in this tournament. And consider what happened, not just here today, but Latvia winning its first ever game in group play. They celebrated like they won the gold medal. Czechia upsetting the U.S. They celebrated like they'd won the gold medal. And Canada getting the true golden goal celebration today. I usually take time to thank our amazing crew for giving up their Christmases for the World Juniors. This might have been tougher, giving up their summer vacation when another World Juniors is just a few months away. They are the best in the world at what they do. They did an absolutely terrific job. One of the wildest endings we've ever seen at the World Juniors, as Canada survives against Finland with an incredible save by Mason McTavish and a golden goal by Kent Johnson. It's a privilege to bring you this tournament every single year, no matter what the circumstances. We can't wait to see you all again in Moncton and Halifax. Canada winning gold at the World Juniors. Thanks for watching here on TSN.